It's What the Hell.
Holy Christ on a bike! It's Sunday night at 9 p.m. It's time for the What the Hell Show with Private Drexel and Sumerian. Join in on the conversation on the IRC, on the Ranch Radio Channel, and the Dell Net servers. And now here's Private Drexel! If you would like to email death threats or send mail bombs to anyone you're listening to tonight on What the Hell, email us at info@ranchradio.com or send explosive charges to Box 256, Fort Langley, BC, Canada, V0X1J0, or bother me on ICQ number 51558. Cash or fissionables greatly appreciated. When are you going to die? Listening to the What the Hell Show and those sick individuals we call DJs on Rant Radio.
Let's actually turn on the power.
Whoa, there we go.
Distortion.
Destroy.
Welcome to the What the Hell Show. It's Sunday night at 9 p.m. as usual.
Here we are.
It's probably Drexel being late.
The show where the robot really did go insane and kill everyone in the show.
That's right. If you're wondering what the hell that was Wesley Willis. He's a 350-pound black man on Jello Biafra's label who's completely schizophrenic, and he sings great songs.
He does.
It's beautiful. I may play another one later on. He uses the same exact music for all of his songs. He's released like 5 albums.
That's all the same music.
All the same music.
Seriously.
Yes.
Why would someone buy this? Other than the fact, I guess his lyrics must be just brilliant. Such as AMFDM.
And all the names of his songs are the choruses. Every time.
Well, that's Well, so and big fucking deal. Spice Girls did that, and look how much money they made.
That's right.
Let's. you know, shit. I've heard entire trance albums like that.
And at the end of every song, he quotes some commercial. The tagline of a car.
That's because we are talking into a microphone.
It's amazing.
7.5 minutes after nine.
Well, you're late.
You're late?
No.
You're late.
You're
no, we're no, early.
We're not interested in talking to you too much.
KMFDM.
KMFDM. That's great. Oh, it's because you came late.
How come? Hey. Darcy, how come last week you, like, exhort us to go see the flight?
Ah, here it is. Yeah. Here it comes. Here's the nail.
You, like, tell here's us we have to go see it. You mention it. You bring it up. We go see it. You don't come.
Because I saw it the night before.
And? Well,
and I decided that I didn't need to see it again two nights in a row.
Then why did you try to make us go see it?
Because it's a really damn good movie,
Drexel,
and you hadn't seen it yet.
Drexel, I have no clear recollection of the events you mentioned. That's the response.
No, I don't need to lie. I have no need of lying.
No, I have no need.
No clear recollection.
You know what the truth is?
Yes.
When I brought it up, I did not believe that you guys would, like, go for that.
Hey guys, skip out.
It's a really good idea.
Skip out on the show early and go see Fight Club. And he's like, they're not going to do that.
Doing?
Oh, and totally surprised.
Fucking idiot.
Hey, calm down.
That was what'd you do? That could have hurt me a lot for you turning off my fucking phone, cockfighter.
Calm down.
Oh, vicious.
Joke. Humor.
Okay, when you. Turn it off and don't tell me it's not funny.
Are you expecting a call, perhaps?
Yeah.
There we go.
An important one.
Oh, okay.
Life or death.
Someone you're not
going to
hang up on?
Someone you're not going to hang up on. Yeah.
Oh. Be careful that you don't, you know, those reflexes, you know.
Yeah.
You got to watch
who's out. Who used to bring a mic, an extra mic? Because we're, like, missing a mic. Did somebody bring a mic and they don't bring
really,
it anymore?
That was a really hard hit, though. I
wasn't
like,
that
what?
Hurt.
Yeah, it was.
That was a serious. There was like, there was like, there was like,
vicious
some
intent
behind that. There was like, is everything okay at home?
No.
No.
I didn't hit you in the sternum. I hit him in the stomach. Did
wow.
I miss the stomach?
It's fine.
He's going to get me later.
I'll drop it.
Okay.
I'm angry.
Deal with it, right?
Alrighty. So what's going on?
First,
I'm gonna go around the room.
I gotta tell people how to get on the IRC so they can talk to us and join us. Right. We never tell them how to.
We don't care. We're not.
We talk to
you.
Yeah, you can talk back.
We have
to
some
us.
New people.
Right.
Who's Maddie?
Well, we'll get to that.
We'll get there. Don't jump.
If you want to talk to us and chat with other people listening to the show,
you are so loud today.
I am not loud today.
Your mic is so. Pull the mic away from your mouth. You are just.
How about I turn it down? Because I keep it on the foam. I keep it on the foam. So nobody else uses this.
So I just, you know, to get
to
extra loud today.
To get to the IRC,
pettiness.
If you're internet friendly, go to the Dialnet servers in the Rant Radio channel. And if you're not so smart, you can go to the webpage, www.rantradio.com.
I go to the webpage.
Yeah, Sean regularly goes to the webpage.
Yeah, I'm a sysadmin.
Yeah, he does know IRC.
And I go to the webpage.
It's just
actually,
and then click on chat.
Story.
Click on chat. Yeah, we have like some stories.
And
2 weeks of.
You
guest 13579.
Oh, is that taken?
Neo, yeah.
Is Morpheus taken?
So you got the instructions. We're going to go around the room. We got a few new faces here, so it'll be very, very cool.
Many new faces.
Yes. Okay. Somebody else can take over because I'm going to get on the camera.
Okay, I will take over then. I see.
Gee, what a surprise.
Nobody has to die. We only want the
Control
Star Cruiser.
Freak.
Which is actually true. I think that what we should do is we should have a big union of all the people who listen to Rant Radio. We should all make a pact that if anyone ever gets abducted by aliens, you just repeat this phrase. Nobody has to die. All we want is the Star Cruiser. Why doesn't anyone ever try to, like, what are they?
Hijack
the goddamn Star Cruiser. I mean, I would hijack the Star Cruiser. That would kick ass. Starting off, we have Daxter.
Hello.
Daxter with the short hair, much shaven, and good glasses.
And no facial hair, but that's old now.
No facial hair.
Well, that's old news.
That's old news.
Hello. Up we have girl on the left.
On the right.
And we will
girl on the right.
Girl on the right tonight.
Girl on the right.
I'm still called girl on the
she's
left.
Well,
she's girl,
the girl
on our
on my
left.
Left. So she was
she's girl on our left.
I'm always on someone's left, so you might
turn
as well
on.
Just
politically,
keep
she's
girl
on the
left.
Light. Kitchen light is turning.
Ooh, lights are changing.
Excellent.
Thank you very much. Moving right over, we have me with explosion hair. Because, and my kung fu grip.
See, children, this is why you should never put your thingy in a light socket.
Your thingy. I didn't put my thingy in a light socket. My thingy won't fit in a light socket. If you can ground your thingy on a light socket, you've got a thicker head than I.
Right. You have a what?
Never mind.
A thinner head than I? Wouldn't that be more appropriate?
No.
Not too proud of the size of your ho-ho?
I have a very small dick. My dick is very small. Very,
small enough to small. Fit in a light socket.
I could pick your teeth with it. Matter of fact, I'd like to. Let's go to the bathroom right now. Moving right along!
Changing the topic.
I have no idea what the fuck your name is at all. I know I've seen you here lots. And I'm really
oh my
sorry.
God! It's Psycho. DJ Psycho.
DJ Psycho. Sorry. Sorry about that. I don't even know his real name. Like, he could, like, kill everyone here. It was DJ Psycho. DJ Psycho did it. And then we have Marge, the rocking. And
Hello, Marge.
Special name? Porn star.
Porn star. There you go, Lieutenant Major Jobbies. Lieutenant Major Jobbies, hey, I name her. Yeah, you go ahead there, Tarzan. I name her. No, Lieutenant Major Jobbies, go jerk off and jump in broken glass. Okay. Then we have...
You promised, you said, the next time you
I
came.
Have graphics. I know. I know. There is no mic in this hemisphere of the room.
Isn't there a long pause?
There is no
audio. That's because.
Sorry, this is my mic.
Normally they have a mic down there because I'm down there, but I'm having to sit here tonight because of like space constraints. So.
Maybe Dak can learn to share.
No, I'm not sharing. Forget it.
There you go.
I'm not generous.
I'm willing to give up my mic so others may benefit.
Isn't he sweet, folks?
He's sweet. It's the new Dak. No hair and kind, too.
Girl on the lift. Yes, I girl on the lift. Yes, I work in a warehouse. I sit in the forklift all day.
Well, you're British and you ride the elevator all day.
Yes. Yes, I third floor.
Mr. Okay. Tyler.
This guy here, fighting...
With a mic in his face.
And like a mic stand in his face, yes, getting followed.
If I had a million dollars. If I had a million dollars.
Pretty good, eh?
Yeah,
I got the turtleneck and everything.
It was good. If I could lose some weight, I wouldn't sell so many albums.
There you go.
It's fucking brutal.
I'm cute and cuddly. Buy an album for me.
I'm cute and cuddly. I am liposuction. Tonight, we make soap. Okay.
Oh!
Botch. Okay.
Rancid soap that tastes like macaroni and cheese.
We're going to wash your mouth out with soap.
Oh.
In any case.
I just like to register an official complaint as like the only bare-naked ladies femme in the room. I just like to oppose this string of humor on humanitarian grounds.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah.
We could have Dijon soap. We can go up and go to the fat farm and just open the fridge and stuff.
Stop hitting me. You have been fucking with my hair all evening. Touch my hair one more time. I will
punch
put you into a small ball and...
That was projectile vomit, man.
Oh, who was that, Sim? I have no idea.
Doing what he does best.
It was the burning fucking bush.
Excellent.
And I don't mean the VD. All right.
We have the forehead. Speak, forehead.
Oh, forehead, we look to you for guidance. It is the forehead of our Lord.
Just keep on going.
We can only... And the forehead does pass me by.
Just a disembodied scalp. Move on.
And that's what Jesus said, too. And then people somehow translate it into, don't make any idols of me.
Yeah.
You know, he said, no, just fuck off.
Oh, we got a clear shot.
We got a girl in the back.
The forehead, that would be the forehead.
Hi.
There's Fivehead. That's your new name. That's your online name. You're now Fivehead.
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 That's really bad to be called that and be an attractive woman. That's a bad thing. Bad nickname.
Well, we should mention that apparently Fivehead is actually from Kentucky, if I heard that right.
From Kentucky. I live there.
You live there?
Where are you from?
It's apparently...
You're from
Texas.
Oh, so she can shoot. She's shooting Fivehead.
Damn.
She's sniper Fivehead.
DJ Psycho, I guess there goes most of our armadillo jokes for the evening.
Yeah, that's basically gone. Do they have armadillos in Texas? No, wait a minute. In Kentucky? What the fuck are armadillos anyway? They're big armored rats. What do they eat?
Anything they want.
No, really. What do they eat? They have like long tongues.
Ants.
They eat ants. Well, that's what anteaters eat. There can't be that many ants in Kentucky. Give me a fucking break.
Just not that many anteaters in Kentucky.
Why? Because the armadillos fuck them all up and they all get second chance to become armadillos?
They muscled them out of the business.
Yeah. Hence really. Like,
the protective
armor
plating.
I think all they exist for is to slow people down. They are nature's answer to the speed bump. Because you always see them like cratered on the highway, right? Like, they don't actually do anything. They're just like,
what are we talking
about? What the fuck was that? Oh, that was God telling us to slow down. He sent us
armadillos?
An armadillo. And the Texans, you know, how does that work?
What happened to no armadillo?
And the Texans who love them.
I'm not making an armadillo joke. This is honest. It's like deer on the prairies. It's too cold. They go...
It's like possums everywhere.
Yeah, possums. Like, possums. You ever see a possum alive?
Yes, I did.
Okay, we have one sighting. Do you have a photograph of it? No.
I ran over a possum once.
Of course. Everybody runs over a
possum. No. I ran over it. I didn't actually hit it.
Oh, so you...
It stood there. Looking at me.
It's
the van
alive.
Drove over it, and it still stood there going, whoa, that was
because
close.
It was, they eat.
We ran back and looked at him, and he was looking at us like, are you all right?
And everybody goes, and you know why? Because possums eat mushrooms. That's what they eat. They eat magic mushrooms. That's what they do. That's why, what other animal would sit there and go, car! And then after you drive by, it'll like look at you and go, are you okay, man? To the car, you know.
Now, what I'm wondering is,
danger.
In the opossum world, not like, being right out in the middle of the highway and not getting tagged by a car, now is that considered an incredible stroke of luck, or is that considered a possum failure?
It's probably like the divine wind. Like, they all go to their own funerals and shit, and then they like, try to like, lay siege, and then, you know, they're all, like, living on
I have not been chosen!
The claw! It's like, that's my power animal, eh? Totally. Going to the icy cave, and what does it say? Slide. Great. Well, I'm going to go to therapy the next 2 fucking years to figure out what that means. Fuck my inner child. I got eaten by a possum. Nobody ever has power animals like a slug, eh? What's your totem, huh? It's a slug. Wow, sorry about your luck. It's always like eagles and bears and ravens and shit. No.
Oh, my.
That explains Eastman.
Oh. The way of the mighty sloth. Yes. Hey, case moving right along. And we have Drexel.
That's right. It's
Drexel the Violent.
Yes.
Violent.
Okay. Look,
violent,
you know,
Drexel.
When you're a James Bond villain, you gotta hit people.
No, that's
especially
not,
when they turn off your phone.
That's not true. I have never seen a James Bond villain, the real, and I've seen lots of his henchmen, but I've never really seen a James Bond villain thump anybody. They always go,
did you see the last? Did you see the latest movie?
Yes, I did. Did he punch anyone?
Oh, I'm sure he hit a bunch of people.
Oh, yeah, okay, but he wasn't the mastermind. It was the chick who was the mastermind.
Oh, my God.
The mastermind never fucked.
Who's that?
And Samarian. Sorry, we're talking about James Bond.
That's all right.
It's close.
They can't see him anyway.
Oh, my God, the screen is dark. We need light.
Damn you, screensaver.
Apologies to anyone just like Lemmings. What the fuck is this? Squeamish, LAPD, lawyers. I wouldn't fuck with the LAPD. You know why? Because they have 2 Apache gunships. On issue to them, LAPD, after the riots, I don't know why, but they...
It was given to them for the 1984 Olympics, was why they actually got those Apaches.
Are you sure? Did
yes.
they have Apache guns?
Yes, they did. They never took them out. They never even flew them, quote-unquote, flew
them. They
probably
fucking sold them.
But they basically did actually have them. They were issued to them for the 1984 Olympics.
The LGPD, what the hell is that? Isn't that a radio station? LGBT? What is that, if you guys are trying to say? LG Apache gunships.
Is your mic working over there?
I don't know. Is
good.
It still working?
Yep, still working because the connection is really poor.
O forehead who is bequeathed before us in the kitchen, would you so mightily deliver unto me maybe a Dr. Pepper if you're so in the mood? And the forehead thinks about
so
it.
So on the IRC we have Calamari X.
Who the hell's that?
We've seen them before.
Seen
yep, they've been here
Calamari
before.
Calamari X actually hasn't been around in a while, though.
Yeah, but they've been here before. Critical Shot. L-I-7-A-R-D.
Lizard.
Does that spell? Lizard. Lizard. It doesn't have
SOAB.
Bottom stroke. Sort of like a 3D raised
is
thing, I guess.
Is that our SOAB? Our trade faithful old SOAB?
Where? There's
the
no
bottom.
SOAB there.
SOAB is now known as electronics.
Oh, They just moved. Okay, yeah, I guess so.
Is that Soab? Is this Is that you, Soab? And prove it is by telling me the city that you live in. Because I know what
Lieutenant Major Zombie, Matty Matt, that's a new person too.
Hey, Lieutenant Major Zombie, how you doing, you little psychotic?
We missed you so much.
We missed
much.
You, Lieutenant Major Zombie, and so did girl on the left.
Especially.
She was especially missing you. She was asking about you earlier today. That sexy man, I saw his picture on the on our webpage.
Oh, yeah.
That cute little mustache.
That cute little Whispy. Mustache, sexy man, who are you talking about?
Wispy mustache. There's a Lieutenant picture Major of Zombie. Lieutenant Major Zombie on the webpage.
Really?
Yes, there is.
Oh, yeah. You look at the webpage, do you? All right.
Yeah.
We'll just believe everything you say for now on.
I don't
on.
Have to work at the webpage. Look at the webpage. I work here.
Lieutenant Major Zombie is sending me to a page.
Hey, what happened to the pictures of Gloom
Matty
Bunny's...
Matty Matt. I see Matty Matt.
I'm scared. I'm too scared.
Have you looked at them?
I have. I've received
I still
them.
I have
and...
not seen them.
Yeah.
Just imagine
they
fat,
will get up there.
Large seething
probably
fat
this
things
week.
With nipples on them. There you go. That's
and we've got Shazbort, Skip Radio, and Wild Card.
Hey, Wally.
Yep. So we're going to go to the news. I don't know if I'm going to go to that page. What is that page, Lieutenant Major Zombie? You can warn me or tell me what it is. Repeating kick.
That sort of thing, but if done correctly, it can be quite enticing. However... This was not done correctly, nor was it enticing. Hence,
this picture?
Like a virgin. So, I am not being nice. Fuck that. People don't tune in to listen to me to be nice.
That's right.
True. That's true. Very true. People, apparently Sam has been telling me, people every day, all day, download
all
my
day long.
Off the fucking page. All day long.
I come to my computer, and there's somebody downloading. If you want to download it, go
Nothing
to FTP.
Nothing amazes me
FTP.
More.
FTP.rantradio.com.
Like, that scares the living shit out of me. I started doing these rants as a fucking gag.
Now there's it minions
was,
of people
It was a
downloading.
Joke. Now there's like, no shit, I go off and do these rants. Five-head shooters.
You know what you should do?
Know what I'm talking
you
about.
You should basically start a little camp for all your ranters.
I am. This is what the Seraphim is. And the Seraphim is coming.
The next step, Sean,
they
is,
are coming.
Is changing your name to Preston Manning.
No, what the next step is to, I'm going to have this old dilapidated house, and then I'm just going to have people, and they stand there for 3 days, no food.
They can come in, yeah.
Wait,
they'll be my
I've
own private little space monkey.
I've heard this before somewhere.
Yeah. Well, it's,
space monkey kick. I'm tired of you and your space monkey kick.
The first rule of Rant Radio is you do not ask questions. Okay, anyway, so... no, but seriously, like, people are downloading these rants all fucking day. And it scares the living shit out of me that a lot of people are, like, listening to me and going, wow, this guy's really cool. Because in a lot of my rants, I talk about shaving down 2x4s and caving people's fucking heads in, you know? I know what's going to happen. Someone's going to shoot somebody and scrawl my name
Sean Kennedy told
Sean
me.
Sean Kennedy, the fucking man, you know? Like... I'm going to get a letter from fucking Mr. Manson there, not the Maryland type, okay? And he's going to be like, oh yeah, I used to think John Lennon was the man, but fuck the White Album, song track 9? No, 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 it's Rant Radio now. And I'll be like, that's great.
I wonder if you did a search on one of the MP3 search engines, if you would find your rants reproduced anywhere
on Napster.
On Napster,
oh
how cool would that
my
be?
My name on Napster.
Yep, later. Sean K. Just type that in.
Sean K. See if it. Oh my God, I would fucking. If anybody listening wants to do like any kind of a music mix with one of my rants, that would just kick my ass.
You realize, of course, you would basically be feeding his ego to quite literally Gojira
level.
Don't
you think it's big
abortions.
Enough for today?
And of course, that remix would have
enough?
To be done
his
with
ego?
9 Inch Nails and Iron Maiden.
No, anything would be good. I don't give a fuck. There's no rules, but I always thought that'd be very sly. I don't think it's going to show up. You might get that Sean K. and the Crazy Cats fucking guy who actually owns a site. Some guy named Sean Kennedy and the Crazy Cats has a website. No shit.
Sean K.
and
the Crazy Cats.
Because we look up SeanKennedy.com and some asshole named Sean Kennedy and the Cool Cats or some shit like that has the site. And I'm like, oh, look for Sean K. on Napster. No luck. Well, we need to do that. We need to do Sean
Kennedy
on MP3.
No matching songs. Got to share them.
Actually, well, yeah, put them in MP3.
Do we have to have
this? No, it's all the same. You type in anything in either of those, it doesn't matter. Unfortunately, well, I'm going to go to the promo for the news, so...
Come on, everybody. Feed his ego. Feed his ego. Why do you guys care? This is a really crazy shit.
It's now time for the news and web pages of the week. If you have an interesting news item or web page, send it to me, Samarian, at ICQ number 51558. And now for the news of the week.
and scares the shit out of me. You know what you have to do in order to keep people like Shazbok and Critical Shot under control? You have to be crazier than they are.
That's right.
The fucking deal.
Are you leaving us?
She won't
the
speak.
Forehead nodded.
Yep.
The forehead has spoken, and she's taking five-head shooter with her.
Bye.
Good. We can make American jokes now.
Wow, she's got like an SS leather jacket. We gotta get a close up of the SS leather jacket.
It's a Gestapo jacket.
This is the Gestapo jacket.
They have airs of making
with
a talk.
Floral interior.
How old are you, Mazar? You have to show off the Langley shirt. You have to do like the poser down girl thing.
Move the hair.
Like the big, move the hair. Strike a sexy pose.
There we go.
Do
Langley, get that.
There you go.
You realize, of course, you're giving Lieutenant Major Zombie like shower material.
Yeah. Just
get
no,
it in.
No.
Just
though,
walk away. Leave the gas. Walk away. There's been too much bloodshed. Okay.
Okay. Zoom back out. So it's time for the news. Let's see, what do we got?
Cena Kennedy. Yeah. That rate, I don't think you'd have to worry if they misspell your name. While they're carving it in someone's chest.
That'll be my defense. No, that was Cena Kennedy. That's
Cena.
The well-known other ranter. Buy it.
Electronics X, think it's been too long since I've listened. Yes, it has been too long. You have to listen every week.
It's been too long since you listened.
Of course, no, except last week, because there wasn't really much of a show.
It was like 45
week.
Minutes, and we went saw Fight Club, which was worth it. I mean, geez, we did the show.
I want to apologize to everyone that we did it, but however, I have to say that it was worth doing
it.
I really, really,
we did
really
have a show.
Enjoyed
it was a
that
one.
Movie.
Oh, yeah. Fight Club.
Which one? Fight Club.
I'm sorry, no, I was doing six different things. Subject Whiplash all over the place.
Yeah, Subject Whiplash. It's key. Slash Dot.
Uh-oh.
News for nerds, stuff that matters.
What are we going to do now?
We're going to do the news. BMG's new copy-protected audio CDs. Oh, no!
Is this the stupidity I heard about where something that was something else you were telling me about, wasn't it?
There's another proposed standard, same idea as DivX, sort of, except it's... you have like about 3 days to watch whatever DVD movie you watch, and
it's
once
already
it in,
over.
That's come and gone. They came out. They tried to do it. That you buy the DVD, it dies after 3 days.
Yeah.
That hit the shelves. It tried to work, and they killed
it. Is this for DVDs?
Fucking cratered.
No. Is this for DVDs? Yeah.
It was
way too late.
Yeah, it fully cratered.
It's now, way too late now.
This is going to set
What's
me
too
off
late?
Because
to do anything with DVDs BMG's now, to introduce like a new style of DVDs that's going to die. They're already selling them.
No fucking way, man.
DVDs are the fastest catching on technology ever. Faster than CDs, faster than videotapes ever.
Oh, I wonder why. They're fucking brilliant.
What did they say it was? That basically it went from no sales to basically in 6 months something like 25% of all homes.
Over Christmas, man. Everybody
bought
DVD players.
People bought them?
You're an idiot if you don't
like
DVDs.
I want to get one. I mean, I'm not even a movie person of any kind.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hope no one's sacking Anki over there.
I think Anki just got sacked quite painfully.
Second, totally second.
Walk it off.
What did I do today?
Walk it off.
Second, lock yourself in the bathroom, puke in the tub. Back to the news. PCB writes, I found the following, www.heise.de, BMG Entertainment. Started selling audio CDs using Cactus Data Shield. Oh no, I don't suppose Loft is going to fuck those guys like they stole something. A copy protection system developed by Midbar and Sonopress, which makes it impossible. That's a scary word to use.
Impossible.
Impossible. Using impossible. Why don't you just say dip the fucker in like blood and throw him to the hacker sharks. Anyway.
This is impossible. Go.
This is impossible. You can never defeat us. Oh, wait. Before the press conference ended, yeah, there's a call to war. What makes it impossible to grab music from the CD and listen to is using, quote, an old CD player, unquote, or a CD-ROM drive.
People are going to be really happy about that, huh?
It used on the albums Razorblade Romance and by him and My Private War by Philip
Wait, I just
Bowen.
Bought both of those CDs.
And
where
the
are
Voodoo
they?
Club. Yeah, who the fuck are those?
I imagine they're German bands.
Well, the thing is, it's like, oh, thanks for telling us, because now we know what albums to buy to attempt to rip from. What's worse, the copy protection is not even mentioned outside on the CD case, and as the CDs are not really Red Book compliant, they actually do contain CD digital audio. You need to use the Fishmany language to translate the appropriate native tongue.
Okay, so what are they saying? They're saying
you can't, if you buy the CD, you can't actually play it in an old CD, or you can't rip the music.
You can't play it.
It
in an old CD player, and it will not play in a CD-ROM drive.
So basically,
so why would they want to do that?
No, in an old CD player.
Yeah, or a CD-ROM drive.
It will play in
a new CD-ROM drive.
If you've bought a CD-ROM drive in the last X many years, well, I'm sorry.
At all. It won't play in any CD-ROM drive.
No, it just said no CD.
While listening to this CD.
So you have to have bought a recent CD.
Can't play Quake.
A CD player of recent vintage.
Yes, a CD player. So all the people with the ones in their cars, they put it in, it goes...
thanks a lot.
Excuse me while I return this fucking thing. It won't play in my goddamn drive.
It doesn't work.
Good plan.
Thanks for coming out.
Great copy protection.
It's great copy protection. You don't want to copy it because it doesn't work at all.
The song probably sucks ass anyway. Whatever happened to all I ever needed to know I learned in fucking kindergarten? Whatever happened to that? Whatever happened to that word starts with an S, ends with an R, E, kind of a sharing idea? What happened to that? You know, like, I'm sorry, Mom, I can't pass you this salt. This salt is copy protected. You know?
Well,
fucking dad, were you licensed to tell me that bedtime story?
Were
you licensed to tell me that? Because I need to know if you were licensed to give me that bedtime
story.
It's
more important to them to protect the music from copying than to actually let the people who have legitimately bought it listen to it.
Lieutenant Major Zombie says you can play any CD in a ROM. I don't think so. If it's not made to standards, it'll spit it out and not do anything.
It'll just say you put some kind of shiny silvery thing in here, but it's not a CD. I don't know what the fuck it is.
Yeah.
Spit.
It's not compliant. It's not Redbook compliant, which is the standard for CDs. They just didn't go with the standard, so it just won't play.
I think eventually what they're going to do is they're just going to... I think eventually what they're going to do is they're just going to take all of the great works of art from now until the end of time, and they're going to have them recorded, and they're going to have it all translated down to one nice, big, shiny CD.
Yep.
They're going to go out into the desert, they're going to bury it 10 feet down, they're going to release a couple of reviews. Oh, man, you would have liked this so fucking much. Unfortunately, none of you are going to get to play it because we're afraid that anybody's going to listen to it and want to, like, listen to it without paying for it.
Rip the fuck out of it, man. Rip the fuck out of it. Who cares? Who cares? It doesn't work? Oh, well, don't buy it. Buy it on vinyl.
There you go.
Buy it on audio. Rip that fucker to MP3 and throw it on Napster. Thanks for coming out.
Distribute it.
Right, you want to suck my what?
Is anybody basically doing vinyl anymore?
Mm. Oh, yeah.
Oh, fuck yeah, man.
So vinyl is still around.
Vinyl is hard.
Oh,
like hard.
Anything played at a rave? It's on vinyl.
Almost all vinyl, man. Vinyl is like... There's a whole cult
hardcore punk musicians all release on vinyl.
You need vinyl if you're gonna be mixing at a rave or whatever.
Not true, but it's easier.
Well, yeah.
You can mix with CDs. You can speed up, slow them down.
I imagine
it is a lot more difficult.
You can't do like the nifty hand scratches.
That's right. Yeah. Rap groups.
I remember when that shit started.
Almost
up
all
in New York.
Every rap album is released on vinyl too.
But is like real music released on vinyl?
Hey, man.
Real music. Definition, please.
Police raid teen hacker's home. Police have raided Larvik home in the Larvik home of a teen. Is that Larvik? Is like a country? What is that? Is that a city or what is that? Larvik.
The Larvik home.
In the subsector of Fly. The police have raided the Larvik home of teen charged by some of the world's biggest entertainment companies with stripping them of their music and firms. The boy broke the code protecting video CDs. Kill him!
This is scary. Read the next one.
He hasn't actually copied anything.
He
made a program which was capable of...
Entertainment industry giants including Sony, Universal, MGM, and Warner have sued the 16-year-old Norwegian.
Wait, U.S. companies suing a Norwegian?
Accused him of hacking his way through the clothes meant to control viewing and copying their products. They also charged he publicized the code on the internet. The teenager published the code. Yeah, you want to try to prove that? The teenager published the code on his homepage of his father's company. His father is also charged. Excuse me while we make an example of you and swing you on the yardarm. Special police units and prosecutors. Special police units.
Because he's dangerous.
Norway.
He's dangerous.
What do you want to bet? They're like, how else are you, Maza? Special police units and prosecutors thus staged a surprise raid. No shit, it was a surprise raid. Hi there, we're the FBI.
You made a program we didn't like.
We didn't like. We're here to kill you. Special police units and prosecutors thus staged a surprise raid on the teen's home to secure evidence. Read everything that has current going through it.
Yes.
Then they questioned him for several hours on Monday. You know, the charges carry fines in prison terms of up to 2 years. Now, here's what I'm thinking. John Johansson, the center of this international controversy. You're 16 years old, and you've already had Sony, Universal, MGM, and Warner.
And by the time you're 18 and you're out of jail, you're going to have a really good job.
Oh, not only that.
Don't worry about it, man.
With one of those companies.
If I had those four companies suing me,
wow.
By the time I was 16, your life is a success, man. It's all downhill from here.
Oh, yeah.
Like, holy shit. Like, what do you want to say? Like, I had an impact. Yeah, I brought, like, the entire media industry.
I cracked DVDs.
Down on me. Yep. Yeah, I'm the guy who cracked the DVDs. You're a god. You just got fucking lit on fire, man. People will be, like, carving your fucking name into people's chests. That's
yep.
awesome.
And it has completely backfired on all of those companies.
Oh,
this
yeah.
program is everywhere.
And do you feel,
everywhere
do you feel
in
big
the
now,
internet.
Sony? Do you feel big that
well,
you're
no,
kicking
no,
the
don't
shit
you,
out
don't
of
you see what this
old?
Is? Once again, this is the corporate mentality of basically anybody who threatens their markability and their basically their share is instantly fucking like crucified. And it's like it doesn't just go with there. It's like everything these days. It's the way companies do business
crucified
now.
Crucified is the good word to use because you know what I see when I look at this? I see martyr. And the way I see it is, yeah, great. Well,
oh,
wait until we start ripping the DVDs and recordable DVDs come down in price because yep. motherfucker... Let's all just do it for Mr. Johansson.
The drives
okay?
are still 5,000, so it's a
thank
little
you.
Out of reach. Still.
It's like, gee, if we sue him, the program will disappear off the internet and the problem will go away. No.
That's
no,
it
won't
yeah.
go away. You'll,
it's like, yeah, it's like, and what do they
think? All right, all right, all right. But what are you saying? They found a guy, and I'm not going to argue whether or not they should be able to sue him, but if they can... Yeah, they're going to sue him so that other people might think, I'm going to get sued and my life's going to get destroyed if I make a program like this. It makes sense for them to want to sue him.
The problem is that most of the time if you get sued, you don't get special police knocking down your door and taking stuff out of your house and interrogating
you. What the hell's up
you.
With that?
That is not, that is, that is, network. That is like...
That's the government being the tool of the corporations. And I mean, I hate to sound like...
Foreign corporations.
Foreign corporations.
I hate to basically sound like a bunch of, like, you know, conspiracy anti-business nuts, but this is what this bullshit is turning into. Corporations are basically international, basically multinationals, like Sony and basically...
Or they could
MGM.
Just have copyrights in that country because they're selling shit there, and if they don't have any copyrights there, then it's... automatically free for everyone.
It's basically,
and it's okay to copy it. It's legal if they don't have copyrights.
No, I agree with you in that,
so they have
that every company
there.
Does have to basically protect their own right. But the thing is, we're talking about situations where the police are acting, quote-unquote, special units and police.
Okay, but who wrote the special units? Is the... You know, narcotics section of the police department a special unit? And does that make them Nazis? No, they're out there to get people selling narcotics and fucking people up. You guys are reading into this to see what you want, to see a conspiracy. And I'm not saying there's not a conspiracy there. I don't have enough information. But neither do you.
Actually, this one is something that I have actually followed, and not just in this article because, well, I surf all day because I'm a sissy. Mm-hmm. But... The truth of the matter is what is the answer to this? We're going to be seeing more and more and more to this. And I would like to take the answer from Islands in the Net, Bruce Sterling, the idea of data piracy islands, the concept of having a place where someone will
host all this
get
stuff?
A small community or an island or an offshore area, which they either declare as part of a country's laws. You find a country that... You can either work with or whatever, but if you had a place where you could post, and that country's laws has no data extradition treaty, nothing, all we need is for some fucking group of people to go, yes, you can use encryption, send it to me, and we'll post it out from there.
I guarantee you that the fucking international governments would not allow it to occur.
What are they going
to
do? They're going to bomb it?
They would literally
just go to war with
it.
Them.
They would
but
literally
here, you're missing
it.
The point.
WGO
the point
will
is,
come down upon you.
The point is that... You're saying people shouldn't be able to copyright shit, and that's wrong. If you're an artist and you have music and, you know, people want to listen to it, you should be able to sell it. And people shouldn't be able to just, I mean, okay, I'm a hypocrite because I'm going to copy it, but I'm not going to sit here and say that I should be allowed to.
Oh,
I
absolutely.
Shouldn't be allowed
it's,
to.
Absolutely.
The thing is, though, is
and
the
they should be able to try and stop me.
It's the difference between making it illegal to copy stuff and making it illegal to own a recording tape player. I mean, that's the kind of difference we're talking about here.
Mm-hmm.
They're making it illegal to even have the technology to be capable of doing the copy.
Yep, they've fought that all the way along.
Every time. They basically were trying desperately to make burnable CD burners illegal.
Yes. When they first came out, they tried to make them.
They fought like a motherfucker. That's why I bought mine right off the top.
They tried to stop VCRs when they came out. They tried to stop
double cassettes as well. Double cassettes. They wanted to ban the double cassettes.
They basically, what they're looking to do is, I understand they're trying to protect themselves, but it's more along the lines of, it's basically they're trying to stop things. And it's not just here. Like I was saying, I watched a special. I know this is kind of getting off the subject, but it's the same exact thing. I watched a special today on space. Which is our local technology science kind of station that we have out here in Canada. And they were talking about
Star Trek.
They were talking about do you remember cold fusion?
Yeah.
Okay, when the scientists released the two chemists released their data on cold fusion, they didn't go through quote unquote the normal thing, which is to first publish in the technology journals, allow peers to basically review it and take it apart, because they were told by their attorneys, by their peers, that just publish this, just release the information on this because it's that big.
Mm-hmm.
Immediately.
They were locked down.
They were like hit with all these different people saying, well, this is a complete load of crap.
Oh,
this doesn't
work.
This doesn't happen.
Hoax.
Yet hundreds of people have basically reproduced this experiment now, yet no one.
I have to question that. Does anybody else heard that hundreds of people have reproduced this? Because
I
have read about it, and it's like...
So it's a media suppression kind of thing?
I've ever read is, no, we've tried and tried and tried, and we can't do that.
Mm-hmm. But have you
and
ever
we keep
no-
trying, and
have
we
you
keep
ever noticed
trying, and it would be great if we could, and we're still trying,
It's amazing that every area that you basically see... respected quote-unquote chemists and physicists who basically couldn't reproduce this are all universities or organizations that have extremely large grants from the energy industry.
UCLA, all that good stuff.
So what you're saying, they want nuclear power to stay out
there
polluting the environment?
Yes, they do. Yes. Yes,
fusion,
in fact, they do.
Fusion,
yes.
Fission.
Why?
And basically,
because of the oil companies.
It's all about the dollar. Nikola Tesla can broadcast electrical waves through the air to be picked up. Proven. Replicated many times. Can do it in high school. No shit. You can take an antenna, throw it on your car, run enough power from one of these broadcast towers. You set them up.
To run your car.
It would be less steel to even have the pylons, those big fucking pylons. You'd use less steel to build these towers. It has more range than a cellular control tower. You can broadcast power like a radio wave.
Tesla.
It's been replicated.
Like a radio wave. And then you're frying people. No.
It's safe. It's totally safe. I'm not an electrical engineer.
Right,
I can't explain
it.
But
all
the
reason
it,
why,
so
but all
the
corporations
that's
don't
not
want
done
you to do
that. Is the same reason why they outlawed dope, because the paper industry would lose their fucking shirts.
Why electrical cars aren't everywhere?
Because the gas companies would lose their fucking shirts.
Remember,
it's all
basically
about the dollar.
In the year 2000, the year 2001
exactly.
was supposed to be.
How are you going
to
monitor fucking taking in radio waves? You can't charge. You can bet if they could charge you for listening to a radio station, fucking A, they would. I give you cable. Same idea. Exactly. Same
I've got
the year in California, the year 2001, the emissions control. What was it? Emissions control. I can't remember the exact name of the organization. They were supposed to, literally, all 10% of all cars on the roads in California were supposed to be zero emissions.
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah.
They, however, decided that they couldn't do it. And there was no reason why they couldn't, because they had cars that weren't the greatest cars, but literally...
they moved.
They moved.
Dollar fuel cell.
Good for people that drove around town.
And especially for inner cities.
Yeah.
And basically, they pushed it back to 2010. Then
Because the car companies just said, no, we're not
going to
do it.
They literally told them they weren't going to do it. The car companies just said no. Why did the car companies say no? Because of the oil companies.
Okay, well, you know what? You guys, mm-hmm. you're worried about the oil companies, but they're going to lose.
No. Eventually. We're going to lose.
No. They're going to lose. Like,
let's
see. Oil, limited resource. It's going to run out.
But these people do not think in the long term.
It doesn't matter. My point is that they're going to lose.
Hold on. We would literally pollute ourselves to death before we would run out of oil. So, like, running out of oil is not the problem. It's polluting our atmosphere to the point of total uselessness that we have to worry about. And that's the one that's going to sneak up on us.
There are electric cars out there already, just pure electric. Yep. They have a hybrid electric car out there right now.
Yeah. And that's what they're pushing
that
now.
That is a fantastic idea.
And that's what some of the military
you'll get half and half, and then we'll have all these electrical stations set up, and people will still be able to...
It's
a good way to ease it in.
It is a fantastic way to ease it in, because you can drive your electric car by going to the gas station and getting gas, and it's still a much better fuel economy because you're not wasting so much mechanical energy.
But,
right?
By the way, I'd like to say something else. We've all been basically kind of like talking about cars, and I'd like to say that we have literally bought into the lie in the fact that people say
you
that
turned
cars.
My mic down, didn't you?
Are basically
really
the
bad.
Main polluters. They're not.
Back up. It's too quiet now.
It's been proven time and time again that cars make up, as bad as they are, less than 10% of the total pollution that actually occurs in the atmosphere.
So who's
the
responsible?
Industry. It is industry.
Yeah.
Most companies basically, whenever you see those friggin' factories where you see steam basically pouring out of it, trust me, that's not steam.
Yeah.
Corporations have pollution credits, is what they have.
Yeah, and they literally basically get away.
They can sell these. If one company doesn't use up all its pollution credits, they can sell it for money to another company.
See, and that's exactly why. And this entire thing is exactly why that I'm starting the Seraphim. So I can gather all the crazy little motherfuckers together and we can burn this shit down. This is bullshit. This is fucking crap. Well, you can't
paint happy faces on big buildings
big
and fire
faces.
Eyes.
Fuck yeah, man. Yeah. Fuck yeah. Like, when is
take down the credit
go,
card companies,
wait,
huh?
This is fucked. It's all fucked.
Sasport's basically right on his statistics there. About 70% of power we basically use is made by coal and oil. That's down in the States.
Yeah.
Up here in BC, fortunately, we have enough water to make basically a hydroelectric system that works. But that's why things like cold fusion or basically even, forget about that, just nuclear. Okay, I mean, people like rag on nuclear because it frightens the hell out of them, and I agree. They haven't come up with a really great way.
Well, there's that whole toxic waste problem.
Of taking care of the waste.
Yeah,
but
they do have a way
to get rid of the toxic waste, but people...
Burning it into glass. I heard about that, yeah.
No, there's another way.
Yeah.
They dump it into the ocean, and of course you say the ocean and toxic waste, and everybody goes,
ah!
Yeah.
But no, they take it into the trenches that go basically to the bottom of the earth and then, you know, sucked beneath the core.
If that works.
It would work, and it would be safe.
Totally destroy it.
It would be safe, but as soon as you say toxic waste in the ocean, it's automatically vetoed because no one will buy that.
But
because, well, what if one of them breaks open or whatever, right?
Yeah.
And I'm sure those people on the ship really give a fuck. They've got a load of toxic waste. They're 20 miles offshore. Is this the right area? Yeah, the machine says
What's cheaper, dumping it or dumping it in the right place?
Let's fucking go.
When we're talking about nuclear energy, what I'd be more interested in, there's other stuff like, you know, wind power and, like, actually developing really useful solar power.
Yeah, thermal, geothermal power.
And then you don't have to fucking worry about all
that's
this.
Right.
All this and nuclear waste,
and
you don't have to have people mining for it, and you don't have to...
When you're talking about the care and handling of nuclear materials, well, there's little details like, you know, the...
Turn my mic up.
The Pentagon just released this week about handling the nuclear material for their weapons over the past 5 decades and how, like, you know, their workers were, like, tramping around in uranium dust and stuff like that.
Mm. Oh, that's got
to
be good.
And they're just getting around to doing something about it.
It was only a few flipper babies! Wow. Fucking step aside or be concerned.
Some of the other things that basically really annoys me is a few years back, this is actually when I say a few years, it was more like 1978, Norway and basically Greenland were looking into the possibility of creating trenches that dug all the way down to the magma layer.
Mm-hmm.
Where they would literally pour the stuff back in.
Pack a lunch. Do you know how long that's going to take?
No, actually there, it's actually very short.
In Norway?
It's up in Greenland, it's less than basically a mile in some places.
Wow, that's some scary shit. I'm digging a fort in the backyard. Who didn't try to dig something in the backyard? Fucking magma.
I was playing
in my tree fort, and then a fucking spot got melted. Very shitty.
That would suck major ass, man. You're
you don't have to worry about it. In Greenland, there are
no trees.
Here
we are. No trees. In the garden, yeah. Painting the
Greenland's not
sport.
Green. It's totally
Iceland
white.
Is green.
Iceland's green.
Yeah. Basically, they were literally talking about basically, and the thing is, the material going back into the magma layer, subducting back down into there, would be no problems because that's where all this fucking material is anyway. Hell, it would be literally recycling the planet.
Yep, that's right. Drop anything in there.
I don't know why. I've never heard anything other than they didn't like the idea of dumping nuclear material. Was what? They were working. They were working on a pressure system that would literally cap it, so that they could literally have
blast
like
it into there or something.
No, it would be a valve system.
Oh yeah.
What it was supposed to be like. You literally have a chamber.
Drop some in, close it over, wait a bit,
and then basically dump it, and then it would then sink down.
Yeah. Yeah. Flush it.
The planetary toilet.
It's a tiny bowl, man.
This is a kind of a scary one.
Jet points to an article in Free, this is on Slashdot, on another broadcasting cable describing how CBS News digitally inserts ads into their New Year's broadcast. Same technology that adds ads into live sports broadcasts. The technology is undetectable. The technology to undetectably alter a still photo has been around for a long time, but only recently has the capability existed to alter live broadcast in real time.
Holy shit!
The CBS news director suggested that it's a good ethical use of this technology, and we're blocking out objectionable signs or covering up a competitor's logo. How can society cope where seeing cannot equal believing? This is justification for the hack.
Oh, yeah.
Right there. Yeah, Bring out the hacker.
How scary is that?
Can you imagine the footage of the WTO conference? Oh, no, those signs aren't saying that the WTO is going to screw us.
Up with up WTO.
All. Yeah, it's saying.
Okay, wait. Yeah. See,
they're saying we're
now,
all commies.
The difference is that they have the technology, so they're already going to use it for what you're talking about for all this crap.
Yeah.
They're arguing, like, some sort of public use of it.
That's what we should
be arguing that it doesn't. Us arguing this is pointless because it's already out there and they're already going to use it against us.
Okay,
so it doesn't matter whether they have some sort of public use for it.
We have to make people aware.
No, I understand that.
I'd like to point out that probably the only logical answer to the situation is what happened in China. That's where they put them up against the wall, shot them, and then charged their families for the bullets. Yeah. Okay, this is about the only way to handle this situation.
Well, yeah, pretty much, where
Jack,
you just
Jack,
have to be
Jack.
A little bit more extreme.
Always the voice of reason.
You know what I would like to see? You know what I would consider an ethical use of this? Is if you could use it just to take out all the fucking ads whatsoever. You know, all those billboards,
hey,
you know?
Well, there you
all
go.
Hack
it.
Know, just like, yeah,
hack
just
that and
it.
Get into the satellite stream.
Nice white walls around the rings.
That's
once
right.
Again, you know?
Or
hey, wait a minute. They're saying you can insert, you can digitally alter the images
anything.
Real time.
Yes.
Holy shit.
Do anything.
Let's go take the satellite broadcast of, say, what's the major show on TV right now?
Wait a minute. Now you guys are the evil ones. Silence!
I confess.
You're evil.
Yes, I am evil. Yes, right here. Me,
you
Sean
are
Kennedy,
using this technology
man.
To evil. Further your own needs and somehow trying to justify it, just as they
actually,
are using this technology for their own needs and trying
no,
to justify
actually,
it.
Actually, what I do is I just simply insert, you know, Sylvia Saint and Taylor Wayne's nude bodies onto Alec McBeal. That's all I'm talking about so that people, you know, will get some real sex out of the whole thing. That'd be great.
What the hell is this and who put it here?
What is it?
Mr. Pibb. Mr. Pibb, no, please stand up, admit your crime now. Who has brought the Mr. Pibb?
That was brought to you direct from the forehead.
Is that a competitor?
And of
to
course,
Dr.
she's
Pepper?
Run away.
That is a no-name market version of basically Dr. Pepper. Mr. Pibb.
Oh, and there's
Drexel's all pissed off now.
There's
Mr. Pibb.
Mr. Pibb, what the fuck is that?
Oh, by the way, I've noticed that recently this group. So I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you. What were you saying?
Give her a mic.
It's the United States knockoff of Dr. Pepper. So she thought she better...
Actually, Dr. Pepper is basically from the States originally.
It's the knockoff.
Made in Waco, Texas, originally named after by a pharmacist, actually.
By the way, I'm going to say that I have officially decided to boycott Coke.
Have
and
you?
If I'm going to be drinking any cola, it will only be Dr. Pepper.
Attaboy. Why is that?
Okay. Do you remember? You might have seen it recently. I don't know if our American, if our American fans have seen this, but in Canada we have a commercial in which this group of kids go out onto the ice to play a game of like hockey. This little girl is like too small to play, and she looks like she's being kept out. And then all of a sudden, one of the big boys goes over, hands her a Coke, and we cut to a line of them all basically standing there, and the girl starts singing the Canadian national anthem like we would before the start of the game. Complete, you know, sweet, a Canadian Anna and all the rest
that's
of it.
That's not sweet. That's aspartame. No, it's really, really sugary, and it rots your brain.
Well, anyhow, I agree. That is basically diabetic shock level. But no, this is the reason why I want to kill them. They made another version in Quebec.
Of course they did.
Where basically the girl didn't sing the Canadian
what
national anthem.
What did she
anthem.
Sing?
She didn't sing anything. She gets out onto the ice, she plays, she falls down, and she accidentally drops the stick right into the puck, and it bounces back into the to the net. Yeah. It's like, and their quote was, no, we're not taking sides in the whole issue.
No, well, they're not taking sides in the whole issue. If you sell a product and you go to, say, I don't know, Jerusalem during World War II, not that it existed, but, you know, say it did, right? And you started playing the Nazi national anthem.
Deutschland über alles, yeah.
The German national anthem. Are you going to sell any Coke? No. You're trying to sell Coca-Cola in Quebec, and they're not going to do that by singing the Canadian national anthem because they don't like it. They don't appreciate it.
But it's like, that's right. they get a little overboard. Like Estee Lauder, for example, this is what you see. Like, okay, there is a compact they were selling. It was a special edition.
It's true.
It was a Canadian, it was a sort of Canadian maple leaf on a compact, all sort of jeweled. They sold that everywhere in Canada except Quebec. You could not obtain it in Quebec because presumably you could be powdering your face and one of the FLQ would shoot you or something.
Now,
I don't understand.
The sick thing about Quebec, I've been to Quebec, you can't buy Dr. Pepper in Quebec. So, and I did my basic there. So I spent 8 weeks of some of the hardest time in my life without Dr. Pepper, and I couldn't have one. And when I came back, luckily my friends, you know, infused me with it. No shit, they met me at the airport with like 9 liters of the shit. It was awesome.
Our swing NCO went out and got some for me.
I feel so fucking bad for you, man.
It was really, really brutal. So as far as I'm concerned, Quebec, and they're all, we will separate against the Canada. Well, why don't we just be, you know, old school about this, and we'll just say, invade, conquer people. Sorry, don't like it. Go to China. Thank you. Hey, you send us your people, we'll send you some of ours. There, have some. They're frogs. You can cook them and eat them. Fuck, we don't care. Why don't you give us all the Buddhists? You can put all the Quebecers in the fucking concentration
camps. Put a gun to their head, say, speak English. Mickey Mouse,
me no die. Yeah, that's right. Pick up your fucking pick.
Like
it's over on
the
right.
I'd like to say I am very, very Irish. So my attitude is that, you know, most people in certain situations do have a right to basically try and reclaim their homeland. I'll give a few cases where I think it's actually a good idea. The Basque separatists down in basically Spain, the Irish in basically Northern Ireland. You know, there's a number of different cases where people should have the right to stand up for their own independence. Mm-hmm. However, Quebec has never been mistreated. Quebec has been given...
Not in anyone's living history, anyway.
Over 100
no, fuck
years.
Fuck living history. Who cares? Okay, Skip Radio has the right
who
idea.
Who the fuck
Paint
won
it.
The war in 1659 anyway?
Exactly. Let's put it this way. Ireland lost a number of wars. We didn't give up until we won back the rest of the country. Now we're basically still trying to get Northern Ireland. And why? Because the English suck dirt.
Well, whatever. Fuck anyway. Yeah, I've got a picture of Michael Collins on my wall. But the point is... All right, the point is, back to the whole, you know, Quebec issue thing. It's like, I really wish we were a little bit more American in some of the things we did, like how we handled the whole Indian issue. We gave them a province now. They should all move there. No more special rights. Everybody's equal. Nobody gets special things. Nobody gets to go to school for free. Fuck that.
That's like the back alley of Canada. Most of it's sad. This is the place that the people in the Northwest...
Yeah?
Close to the mic.
Well, at least we didn't do the American thing and commit genocide. The Nazis killed more Indians than the Germans ever killed fucking Jews. Like, here, have some blankets. Oh, look at that. I got a whole bunch of land.
I'll explain.
They're fucking just taking and taking and taking.
Do you know why the province actually got named Nunavik?
The territory?
Because we wanted
that's
Nunavik.
That's Canada's new territory.
It's a territory.
No, basically, no, this is not a joke. Literally, nobody white answered the questionnaire. I'm not kidding.
Well, I don't really care. I mean, they can name it fucking That's carpal great. Tunnel syndrome for all I care. It's a northern wasteland.
Of all
it's
that just, land up there.
Like the I'm not racist about this, but I just think that people people should be equal.
That would have been great.
Everybody
in the area wants to have the name changed from basically the Northwest Territories.
Everyone on the same level.
I can't argue about natives anymore because I haven't got the answer yet. And I have an answer for everything,
except
I don't have one for this yet.
I have to
We're going to talk about natives for the next hour.
Yeah, but see, the people in Texas actually kick so much ass that they'll they'll shoot everyone. Like,
Canadians
Texas has
talk
a really
about
good
Quebec like us Americans talk about Texas.
Yeah, but the thing is that the people in Texas are actually tough. Like,
the people
in Texas really
together
do have guns and really will kick your ass.
The people in Texas same probably have more guns than the rest of the country put together.
Read the Brent Arwin. From the Australian comedy short, Fast Forward, if our forefathers had done a little more indiscriminate shooting we'd have less of an Aborigine problem. Oh, geez, Sean Kay's never been down to a reservation.
Oh, yes, I have, in fact. Yes.
Kurt Bird
yes, in fact,
us.
I have. They suck monster ass, and they're really angry, and they hate me because I'm white. And if people don't think so, I spent 3 years in Manitoba during Dakota days, where if you're white, don't go to town. You'll get fucking killed. Let's talk about racial hatred. I have nothing against Indian people. I just think everybody should be treated equal. I mean, it's shitty. Really sorry. Yeah, we took your land. Yeah, we fucked your culture. Yeah, we destroyed basically all
your
ideas.
No. We didn't fuck their culture.
Yeah,
we didn't
we
take
their
land. We took their ancestors' land. And no, we didn't. Our ancestors.
Well, whatever.
Didn't.
Basically, white people fucked up their culture. And, oh well, grow up, move on.
Give everything back to the Romans, too.
That's right.
No, I mean...
No, what about
exactly
the Mongols? Give
exactly
it all back to the Mongols. Wait, who is before the Romans?
The Proto-Europeans.
Give it back to the Neanderthals.
Give it back to the dinosaurs.
They had Europe. Modern man moved in there.
What about the poor...
We've got the technology. We'll get Carl on the left working on cloning. Like, we'll get some cells from Neanderthals. We'll bring back the Neanderthals. We'll give them back Europe.
And say sorry.
And say sorry we took it from you.
What about the poor dispossessed lungfish that first
That's right. They made it onto the land.
God help the lungfish, eh? God help the lungfish, the bloated, the tired. God bless the lungfish who got so fucking fried. God bless the lungfish and how he crawled from the sea. God bless the lungfish and fuck me. Give me a break, man.
All right.
Jesus. You got to draw the fucking line here.
I think we have the beginnings of a benefit concert here.
That's right.
I'm serious, man. Celine Dion's last benefit fucking concert, man. God help the fucking lungfish, eh? Fuck me. Seriously, man. Give me the button. I'm voting for Worf, man. I want Worf in fucking charge. Warrior way this whole fucking thing.
I have one word that
Closer.
Would, one word that would solve this.
What's that?
Big smack.
Thank you, yeah.
Big smack.
Sean, if you put Worf in charge, all right, they're going to make you do drill. They're going to come to your house, they're going to put the green uniform on you, sorry, the olive drab, and they're going to give you a beret, and they're going to say, carry this gun around, attention, you know.
In all fairness, if they're saying, Sean, you know what, we're going to make it a level playing field. So would you please put the olive drab back on? We're going to give you a rifle and get you to help. I'd say, sure, and you know what?
No, you
got a whole lot of friends.
Your first target, Celine Dion, and that goddamn lungfish she keeps in her house.
God, danger.
Okay, this next story is.
This is brilliant. I want one of these
for
my lawn.
This is the last story we're gonna do for a news story.
This is so fucking great.
Meet the hologram teacher. The teacher's not really there. Technology now allows pupils to be taught by a virtual teacher who could be many kilometers away. I'm actually gonna post this on the IRC again.
It looks like a 3D hologram.
The cool thing is, this looks like the hologram looks like the Star Wars hologram.
Exactly.
It's like, we can't do this quadratic equation. It's too hard for us. Not for the Sith. You know, this is my student teacher, Mr. Maul.
Let's take a look at it. It looks exactly. It's got that green tint.
I can't find the value of X.
And yeah, but it's
translucent.
Right?
It's 3D.
3D hologram.
We're doing holograms now.
Okay, but the
we're doing
Star Wars
now
hologram was two-dimensional.
Was it?
It to, you know, just look.
No.
Obviously, it was two-dimensional.
But
they didn't make a hologram. It just all they did was take a black and white television and get rid of the background.
They're actually doing.
That's what the hologram was in Star Wars.
No, hang on.
Sorry.
Hang on a second. The Luddite is having trouble with this here. Okay, they're actually doing holograms now.
That's right. 3D real-time projection.
That looks like Star Wars.
Okay. All right. Look, I know it's the 21st century. I know I'm 30. I'm going to be 34 years old this year. I'm not handling this well. Okay. I'm going to be honest.
Holograms.
I'm just not handling this shit well. Okay.
We have a place for you. Join the server and pick up the bastard sword on the right. We'll be giving you a call. Thanks for coming out.
Yeah, it's like because you know, actually having real live human beings teaching our children is just too expensive.
Well, come on.
For such a minor
You guys
priority.
Object to everything. They don't object to everything. Oh my God, they're making purple Smarties these days. What, like the blue ones weren't good enough? Now they've got to be purple.
Yeah, because we're the ones that do so much of the bitching around here.
you know what though? Are you trying to tell me you can't
just go
think?
With the flow.
Are you trying to tell me you can't think of a useful?
Of course, there are good uses, but I keep thinking that there's going to be the temptation to use this to spread resources really thin. You know, there's going to be the temptation to use this. Oh, we can just have one teacher for 30 classes now. That's the kind of thing that I'd be worried about. This is going to be obviously excellent for like a lot of university type application.
Okay,
like,
having
like
a hologram for a teacher is no different than having a teacher on television.
Yeah.
So the point of this is that
cooler.
It's real time and that they're teaching from a distance. And and so essentially it's the same as them having been there. It's not reducing the amount of teachers you need in any way. It's not like they have some recorded hologram and somehow that's better than having a teacher on television.
I basically went to school back in New York when we had a massive teacher-student ratio problem back in the 70s and the 80s. When I was there, the average class was 35. I went to one class where basically it was 48 kids for the teacher. My school was basically, I should mention, it was like the second largest in the friggin' city. It was Brooklyn Tech. Mm-hmm. There was like a student population of 10,300 kids my last year there.
Whoa.
And it's probably bigger now.
I think so.
Can I just say something? I don't actually think that this is a great idea or anything, but on one point is it'll actually save taxpayers a lot of money on sending teachers to jail for abuse and having babies with the students.
There you go.
Hey, but you know what? I don't think the taxpayers are paying all that money, that much money on that right now.
Well, actually, I think the other thing
that
it'll
do is... Does it really
happen
that often? Is that a problem so that we've got to develop a hologram?
No.
Because otherwise, we'd be spending too much money on putting teachers in jail because they're having sex.
Well, no, what?
I'll tell you what I'm worried about. I'll tell you what I'm worried about.
You'd be signing up for my elective.
I'm worried about basically situations where... You have urban areas where, quote-unquote, the kids are so disruptive. Rather than have a real teacher that they put at risk, they set one of these things up.
If you treat people like fucking animals, they're going to react like animals.
Put the kids in the cage. Put the hologram behind bars so they can't destroy the equipment.
God knows if I actually made it through my front door, but if I showed up to class and they put me in like a steel cage, they got guys on either side in riot gear with shotguns, and a hologram teacher goes... Hello, we will teach you instruction today. I'm like, okay, easy Gattaca State. Okay, pardon me, but I'd like to, like, you know, crime does not pay. You know, excuse me, I'd like to skip the whole fortress routine.
Oh my God.
Yellow means death. Why don't we just intestinate the fucking high school kids?
Josh right? K is here.
This is not the solution. This is a Band-Aid solution. What we need to work on is we need to work on the reason why the fucking high schools are so messed up and why all the ghetto youth are so fucking pissed off. Because there are more jobs in America than there have ever been in the past. Yeah, I know. I've got three of them. Nobody's making any fucking money. Nobody's doing any good. The fucking ghettos are getting bigger. There's now the upper class and the ultimate low class. It's turning into a caste system structure which needs to be, shall we say, stopped or, shall we say, destroyed or burned because it's fucking wrong. Multiple layers of wrong. There is no right way to look at this. People sit there and go, oh, well, what are you going to do? You're going to turn it all down? You're going to create anarchy? No, we're not going to turn it all down and create anarchy, but what's going to happen?
happen is it's going to be an intelligent revolution where people go and say, you know what? You're doing all this by making money from us, and we will use things like Napster, like the MP3, like the computer, to stop you from making money so that your empire will eat itself and you will die. This is why the hacker is the answer. This is why
actually,
things can stop it.
I'll give you another answer,
Wait,
too.
I have to do the intro.
What intro? Oh, for your rant?
John Kennedy on Rand Radio.
Sorry about that.
Okay, that was the intro after the actual rant, but, you know.
But it's fucking true.
Continue. No, seriously, if you want to have a problem.
Actually,
like,
that's your line, Darcy.
Like What's Sean that? Was.
It's true.
It's true. Give me
it's
an
true.
It's true.
Like what Sean was saying, basically, when the American Empire does collapse, it's going to take the rest of the fucking world with it. So rather than letting that to actually happen.
You guys, look, you know what? I'm the anti-fascist, okay? I hate fascism.
Jason.
But you know what? There's no other answer.
Yes, there is.
No, there's not. I'm sorry. There is no other answer.
I'm sorry.
The only way to make the world peaceful and happy is fascism.
No.
We need to be more draconian. As Dak has always said, we need to have the government controlling everything and making everyone happy because they won't be happy otherwise. And I really hate that. But it's the only answer. There's no way that democracy is going to work out, not in the way we have it today. There's no way that just having regular capitalism, it's not going
to
work.
I'll tell you
so
basically.
What you're saying is we need to build happy helmets?
No.
Happy. No, I didn't say that. But everything has to be controlled and micromanaged or it's just not going to work.
No, that's not true.
You're
wrong. It's going there. The only thing that will stop fascism from taking control and making the world a better place is a really, 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 really big
better
war
place.
Where we destroy everything and not necessarily start from scratch, but start like
there'll be
over a
bit around.
With fewer people and less order.
I'm going to steal a line.
What we need is a really good plague.
I'm gonna steal a line
I
once
thought that,
again.
I thought that flu was gonna be one for
a little while.
I'm gonna
steal a line from my favorite politician, Al Smith, was a New York
killer. There's
he
like
was basically
coming.
A presidential candidate back in the '20s. Very simply, the only cure for the evils of democracy is more democracy. Seriously, America, especially if you're poor, if you're the underclass, vote. Everybody fucking vote. Get everybody you know that's old enough to vote.
Okay,
get out there and
that's
or
not
evil.
Good
vote.
Enough. How about this? If you don't like the way the government's doing things,
vote.
No, that's not going to work because you're voting for someone else who's going to make a government doing stuff that you don't want them to do.
That's right.
How about you make your own party and stick to some values?
Hey, I got
rather than just trying to win, why don't you run? Why don't you grab some balls and become a politician yourself and stick to your values?
Got a better idea.
And see if you can do it. That'd be great. Because there are no options out there. Because all the options are just other fuckpots that are going to fuck up your country. All of the options out there, when they get into power, they're going to do just as many things you hate as the last people did. They'll just do different things you hate.
I understand that, but the thing is, you see, if everybody fucking votes, guess what these shit heels are going to have to do? Because all these shit heels in office care about is their fucking job.
Reject it.
So,
exactly.
So they're going to have to suck up to whatever the majority wants.
Reject it. Reject the job. Reject the country. Reject the border. Reject all of it. You are now a state. That is it. You are whatever fucking country you want to be in. That was the whole concept that I'm working on. And it's coming. It's in the fucking mail. Don't you worry. All the radio listeners, you're all going to get a chance to get on it. Holy fuck, Sean's had enough.
I think what we need to do is
space
basically.
Space
Monkey Legion.
I'll keep you posted.
Don't you fucking worry.
See, I've been thinking about it.
Slipping it in.
And I'm thinking that maybe I'll become a politician. Because I don't really have, you know, I'm a courier right now. That's not really it. I'm thinking I should be a politician.
Woohoo!
And for the next Langley one.
Skip the politician. Do what I'm doing. I'm becoming a cult leader, and eventually that'll be called king. Because that's all the kings are. I'll take a good
king. Well, I may need to call on you and your cult
any day.
That's right. Vote for Darcy.
Drexel for president.
Run as Drexel.
Well, while you're doing the show, make sure you properly register as a religious organization.
There we go. Drexel for president.
Don't worry. Don't worry. When I get this thing fucking off the ground, it's going to fly.
You know what the problem is? The thing that really hurts me is that if I was running for, you know, office or whatever, Dak wouldn't vote for me.
Actually,
that hurts.
I would vote for you.
All right. Because one more vote. There you go.
I wouldn't actually vote. I just... probably have a bunch of my people come up and protect you from getting shot.
No, no, basically, I would actually vote for you because I know you. Better the asshole I know than the asshole I don't.
That's right. There we go. Hey, go with that angle. Go with that angle.
Fuck that. Stick a gun in Uncle Sam's mouth.
We actually know what the guy, we actually have some idea of what this guy thinks as opposed to, I think children are good because children are our future type sort of campaigning bullshit.
All those answers. I hate those kind of answers.
I can imagine
dance
the first
around the subject.
Mission. He's in like Slovakistania or something. And sorry. First time you wander in like Serbo-Slovakistani-esque or something.
Give the scenario, and both me and Draxol will give you our response to
okay.
it.
Okay, so no, I know what he's gonna do. Some war criminal.
Okay, here's the scenario. You're both sent on a diplomatic mission to.
Skip radio speed.
Hit him.
Elbonia.
Say again. Okay, stop. Give the mic back.
Okay. In the aforementioned fictional Serbo-Slovakistanian country, Elbonia. Not wanting to bother anybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sean Kennedy's Rant Fest 2000 may offend you and make you uncomfortable. If this happens, let Sean know so he can feel his ego swell. This public service announcement is brought to you by Dr. Pemper, the ranter's choice.
Ken writes. All right. Carry on.
Boom, boom, boom.
Sorry. All right, so what is your carry scenario? On. Sorry, okay. Don't cut him off.
Actually, I already had the story all done. Some guy starts getting fresh with this guy. He's in a diplomatic mission. First thing he's going to do, Bowie knife. Okay, cool. Look at that. Probably cut your neck right off. Right down to the spinal cord, right through the bone.
Getting fresh, what does that mean? You mean he's trying to have sex with my ass, or what?
No, fuck a ass. No, fuck a ass. Dude. Seriously, like, they go into these fucking shit-ass countries where, like, all right, we will kill him because he is Serbian. We will kill him because he is Croat. We will kill them because they are Muslim. Okay.
Oh, let's go back 50 years. We will kill him because he's black. Let's kill him because he's white.
Get up on the fucking mountaintop. Stand up on the Serbian mountaintop and say, okay, everyone listen up. If you don't stop fighting, we're going to kill
everyone.
So you will stop this now, or I will stop it in 8 fucking minutes. The average cruise time of the missile. You have 7 minutes 49 seconds to give me your decision, or it's going to be a glowed plug for everyone here. Thanks for coming out.
Okay, we're going to...
The really sad thing is... The really sad thing is, I just end up killing them all.
No, they kill themselves. I gave them the option, stop fighting or die. We choose to die.
No, see.
Everyone who wants to die,
not a choice.
Everyone who doesn't want to die, go over that side.
Boom.
Thanks for coming out. Rolling barrage from my position for the next 5 years.
Returns to the Stone Age.
Fucking A. Oh, as opposed to the war-torn state they're in now. The Stone Age had progression. Now they're just people getting drunk and planting mines every which way but loose.
At least in the
which
Stone
was
Age.
Better? I'll take a spear. Thank you very fucking much. That way my lawn won't kill me. Excuse me. Oh, fuck. But
I didn't catch any of that.
Walk my cow.
I didn't catch a single bit of that.
He was a bit manic there.
Jesus Christ. The Stone Age was a million times better than the fucking mine situation. They're made out of plastic. They fucking come into your house, make you breakfast, make sure you're comfortable, and then blow up. That's how fucking technologically advanced they are now. Holy fuck. Yes, actually, I think we should remove the first 3 feet of topsoil and bury it all. Start fresh. Yes, I think so.
It's actually pretty cool if they wouldn't do that blowing up thing.
you step on them, your relatives, like in Canada, blow up.
Hardwired to your relatives.
It goes backward down your DNA line. Like Neanderthals 5 million years ago going,
Jesus.
It's like...
Oh, well, we're going to go to a break.
Okay,
we're going to go to a break.
Either go to
and
the
then
break
we're
going
to come back
it.
To a gross hospital story. And
there you go.
And you've got... I can't remember what it is. It's like brain lesions or something.
Okay, go to the break or get rid of that thing.
Okay, it's break, and this is Goldfinger with Rio. now,
once again,
it's time for Gross
Hospital Stories. Check. Money order. Cash.
Hello, boys and girls. It's your old Uncle Dak.
Check. Money order.
And your Uncle Dak is about to tell you another disgusting, gross hospital story. But actually, before I do that, I'm going to mention something that's kind of associated with gross hospital stories. Rather unfortunately, and this is not a joke or one of the things, my old partner from when I worked there for 5 years, Trevor Burns,
very cool guy,
passed away on January 2nd from AIDS. Apparently, about 10, 12 years earlier, he had to get some blood transfusion for an ulcer and went undiagnosed for so long that finally it basically had blown into full-blown AIDS by the time they had actually noticed what it was. So AZT and some of the other drugs did absolutely nothing for him.
That
and
sucks.
So a very cool guy passed away.
Mm-hmm. That's really shitty, too, because Trevor was... One thing I remember about Trevor, the guy had nothing but spine. He
was 5 foot six, yeah, and nothing, he would jump any guy, no matter what size it was.
The guy was like fucking tiny, and you would like be in a jam. You'd have like some fucking crack monkey, psycho, crazy motherfucker, and like he'd be like all over Desmond, and
Trevor
would be on this guy. He'd be like, "Oh, Hell's Angels, let's go!" Like the guy wouldn't back down from fuck all.
Yep, and he is.
Yeah, Kurt Burt knew him too. Trevor was small and mean, but a nice guy, like nice fucking guy.
Yep.
Really sweet. Anyway.
Anyhow, okay, getting back to the story. Now, this one evening, I was downstairs checking out the sub-basement because that was just part of my regular patrol schedule. Mm-hmm. And all of a sudden, we get a code 66. Now, code 66 is a physical emergency. That means that the nurses need help because somebody has gone wacko. And I get the call, code 66, 4 south. Uh-huh. Now, I'm in the sub-basement on the north side, and the code
jumps
is...
up through the floor.
So I run. Now, I managed to make it to the second floor before I actually ran out of oxygen. And I had to continue for 2 more floors before I finally got to the top. Uh-huh. So I come out. I'm not breathing. I'm literally not breathing. I've run so hard, I can't breathe. And... I see this guy, he's holding on to the arm of a wheelchair, and he's swinging it around from him.
Broken off the wheelchair.
No, it's basically that they actually do slide out. They can't detach. Okay. So he's got that out, and he's swinging it around going, "Get away from me! I want nothing to do with any of you!" And he's just flipping out. Uh-huh. I can't breathe. I know I'm about to collapse any second, so I walk up to the guy, grab the thing, toss it aside, grab a hold of him, and I go, "Give me a hand," and I fall over.
With him.
Yes. I have
direct
30,
approach.
I have 35 nurses all standing around in a circle around this guy screaming, "Get a blanket, get a blanket," because the standard procedure is you go a bunch of people forward with a blanket to wrap it around somebody when they have a weapon or something.
Totally immobilized. That way, for sure.
Yeah, but I wasn't going to be able to wait.
Fuck that. If I was on the floor, I'm giving a flamethrower.
So I grab the guy. We take him down. No problem.
Yeah.
Now, this guy is about 35, 36 years old, and it's kind of weird. I mean, he doesn't look like the type of person that should be this out of it. Mm-hmm. Over the course of the next 3 months, mm-hmm. we received an average of 2 calls a day to basically restrain this guy.
And why wasn't he restrained?
Because
they
literally had this guy strapped to a bed.
Yeah.
And he would worm his way out, get up, and basically try to leave.
That's called 24-hour watch.
Yes.
I bet you if I'd have strapped that motherfucker to bed, he would have wormed out. I promise you.
Uh-huh. Well, actually,
you've got to think about circulation,
too,
I guess.
Well, that's the problem. You have to make sure that they can actually, they won't cut off the circulation when you tie him to the bed.
Won't cut off the circulation. I just put big, big fucking steel pins through his knees. Ka-chank, and lock those down. There you go.
No, put him in an Iron Maiden.
I'll drive you wherever you want to go.
Put him in an Iron Maiden without the spikes.
Now, I was wondering what the hell was wrong with this guy, and they said that it was apparently, they thought at the time it was Alzheimer's in a 35-year-old male. And it's like, that doesn't make any sense.
Hmm. When
he passed away after about, like I said, 6 months, we finally found out what it was. He had a thing called something plasmatosis. I'm trying to think of the first name of this. Mm-hmm. It is a bacteria that normally lives in the digestive tract of cats.
Oh, this is great.
Okay.
Now, when you basically get it, it will live in your bloodstream. Now, if it lives in your bloodstream, that's fine. It just basically acts like a long-term case of mono. Okay. However, what it
great
can, what it
lose
can,
weight. What I lost it, 40 pounds in 20 minutes.
However,
ask me how.
What it can do is it basically, if it gets into your brain, it proceeds to, and by the way, they didn't know this at the time. What it does is it eats up the, it doesn't actually eat up the brain tissue. As it goes inside the brain, yeah, the long tissues that make up the brain tissue is actually very, trying to think of the right word for this. They're very, yeah, myelin, is that the word?
Myelin,
yes. Apparently,
yeah, what do you know about brain
it
tissue?
Actually causes it actually causes a pions, is that the right word?
Neurons.
The same prions, yes, the same thing that basically is caused by mad cow disease or by
that's nice.
How do you say it again? Yeah, syndrome. Basically, it's mad cow disease. It literally causes that. Now, what this does is the prions are just the regular brain tissue. They're just the regular brain tissue. And the molecule somehow actually changes so that not only does it let go of the rest of the brain tissue, it causes other molecules of the brain tissue to turn into the same exact things. So you have this huge mass of like spongy little holes occurring inside your brain. And it's terrible because a friend
that's
of mine's
great
father actually passed away from the genetic version of this.
Oh, okay.
In which a healthy adult male went in the period of 2 months from being basically, you know, he was a staff sergeant for the RCMP. He went from being an intelligent.
That's a good place for him to be.
Intelligent, bright, friendly man to, by the end, he couldn't even recognize his own daughters and his wife before he passed away.
That's great.
Yeah, wonderful.
That's
huh?
good. I like
so
that.
So same symptoms as Alzheimer's.
Same
then.
Symptoms. Yeah, well, it's worse than Alzheimer's. Basically, the
you get violent.
However, they did not know until
you
just
get violent,
the reason. The reason I remembered this story is because we remembered that basically. I remember that it was actually called by.
There it is. Crucefield Jacob.
Yeah, Crucefield Jacobs, yeah. I remember the story basically coming up from basically the fact that it was actually caused by the plasmoids, the disease that caused by cat shit. Mm-hmm. And they had basically noticed this occurring a number of times, but they had no idea what the hell it was from. And so just recently they discovered that it causes prions.
Another reason for Sean to hate cat shit.
So,
yep.
No. All you basically did is he
cat
somehow
fetish.
Literally got the plasmoids into his system.
And what does this tell you?
You have 9 or 10 cats around your house. You're going to...
No, basically what you should do, don't kill the cats. What you do is you just actually... This is an extreme... Not all, by the way, all cats actually have this in their digestive tract.
Killer molecules tonight on Rant Radio.
But basically, you have to seriously clean up after your cats. You do not let the cat shit sit in the litter box for 6 weeks.
It's a well-known fact that you could probably make me confess to just about anything if you put me in a room with cat shit. There is nothing more disgusting on this planet than the smell of cat shit. Like, your cat, Drexel
Fuzz.
Baby
shit?
No, I will bathe in baby shit. I will smell baby shit into my hair rather than have to deal with fucking cat shit. Cat shit is the most disgusting substance in the world. That is like, oh my God, it's disgusting.
I find it to be one of the least disgusting feces I've ever run into.
Oh, I love to bother cats when they're taking a shit. There's nothing better than bugging a cat when he's taking a shit. You put the kid at litter box in a dark place, he's taking a dump, and he's mid, you know, he's half pitched that low. If you turn the light on, he looks at you with that, oh my God, don't fucking look at me. And you start poking him in the eye and shit. Oh, it's a good kitty. And he's like, oh God. And he's trying to like squeeze off the loaf and it's totally not working. And he's like, oh, and then he's just going to stop his ass from slamming shut. You turn the light back off and like walk away. And then he can like finish his dump in private. And it, like my cat's ass is swollen to 4 feet wide because he will not take a shit. And this is how I solve the problem. He's like those little mites that crawl into your face and eat all the feces but can't shit and then they die. Yeah, it's the same idea.
I had a cat.
Skip Radio worships you. I mean,
I had a cat. Every time I went to go
watch
take a piss, the damn cat would walk into the bathroom to see what the fuck I was doing. This used to drive me fucking insane. So finally, one day, I saw the cat get up, and I basically followed him into the bathroom, and he's trying to take a piss, and I'm standing there staring at him, and I'm like, how the fuck do you like it? And he's like, Cat was like really pissed off. He actually walked out of the house at that point.
Apparently, you can train your cat to shit and piss in the toilet.
It's great. I should find a website with
what
that training on it.
Is you start off with
your litter box. No, you put the litter box by
still
the toilet.
Still no teaching the little bastard.
Then you raise up the litter box to the toilet level. Move over the litter box over the toilet.
And this is over a period of time.
Drill a tiny little hole in the litter box.
Over like
make it wider. Space,
whatever.
Until eventually,
until it's like there is no litter box anymore. He's taking a crap. Then you just like pretty much just stand
like,
there.
Remove the frame. Like, that'll work.
Remove the frame.
No, it does work.
It does
I'll
work.
Wake up in the middle of the night, go to take my dump, and plant my ass in a big fucking sandy kitty litter box. And wow, won't I like that? And the next thing you know, I got killer molecules running up my ass, and my brain's turning to sponge. And won't I like that? No, no, no.
You don't
no,
have a cat,
no.
So you don't have to worry
fucking
about
fucking right.
It.
Sony,
you're not,
I just have
you're not staying
out.
In
I
my
just
house.
Charge.
I just have this mental image. I just have this mental image of this wet cat coming to the pastor's thinking, you bastard, you forgot to put the seat down.
Before we get back onto the hologram story, before I come back
on the and you think your wife is pissed when you don't put the seat down.
You want to hear? Oh, wow, that's really, really nice.
You can blame Lizard for that.
Thank you ever so much for the large heaping sheet pitcher, Lizard. You get to jerk off and jump into the broken glass, Lizard. All right. Enki, go destroy him.
Destroy him.
Funny cat stories by Sean. This is a true cat story. When I was a kid, I had a black cat named Buddy.
Hide your eyes. I'm going to close it.
Okay. Hiding eyes.
Okay. It's
he
closed.
Warned you, and I saw you all looking at the screen. I looked away when he warned me. When he warned you guys, and you're all looking at the screen. Yeah, I'm not supposed to look. Oh, my God. Why did you have to do that to me? Oh. It's like the midget porn on Halloween.
All right. Oh, okay. Yeah, that
oh, my God. It's horrible.
But it's the TV.
Oh, my God. It's just turn it off.
All right.
Turn it off.
The truth of the matter.
Turn it off.
Like, it's a TV.
Stop watching.
Back to the whole idea of the cat story. Sorry about that. I had, Kurt Burt knew Buddy. Now, the problem with Buddy was that he was a cat. I was like 12 years old. I had this black cat, but I couldn't afford to buy cat food for him. My dad was a dick and wouldn't let me buy fucking cat food. So how the fuck is a 12-year-old going to get fucking money for cat food? I don't have a car. I can't go steal a shit. And I live out in Styx, Dooleyville, so it's too far for me to walk and steal cat food. So my dad raises Borzoi, which are these Russian wolfhounds, big fucking dogs, okay? And those are like the love of his life. Anyway, so that's all well and good. That and his car. Fuck you. Whatever. No issues here. So I'm like, fair ball. So what do? I start stealing the dog food because one can of dog food will feed a cat for, oh shit, almost a week. In the beginning, it did. But then, sooner or later, he was going through half a can of dog food a day. But this is specialty bred dog food that has steroids in it. So my cat turns really, really mean and starts attacking my dad in the middle of the night when he goes downstairs to take a piss. He'll like run out of the dark, jump up on your legs, do that back leg on the fucking side of your leg thing, and fuck up your leg, and then vanish, Star Trek style, like boom, beam out, and he's fucking gone, man. You couldn't find that fucking cat with a bloodhound and a Ouija board. He was fucking history, okay? Cat is fucking gone, right? He would attack me like fucking middle of the night, you'd be patting the cat, you know, when you're patting a cat and the cat pat decides, I didn't want to be petted anymore. And he tells you this by, of course, trying to bite you. My cat ripped my whole fucking arm off. The arm came off, threw it across the room. I used to punch my cat in the face as hard as I could. I did not actually realize what the problem was until the cat came home covered with god-awful amounts of shit. He went to Chernobyl, got covered with radioactive waste, came home, and the stench of this shit on him was amazing. I do not know to this day, but wow, if I could bottle it and sell it to Americans, we'd have a brand new bioweapon division. So I go and I'm like, great, so I'm gonna give the cat a bath. I take the cat, put the cat in the bathtub. The cat decides it does not want to be in the bathtub, but it's a bathtub. So he's doing the I'm a living feline lathe back and forth in the bathtub with my hands on his shoulders and on his ass. 30 minutes later, he's getting slightly tired. I take the nozzle, which is like one of those flexi showerhead nozzle things, and go and hose the cat down, and it looks like one of those muscle shirt, you know, kind of like ads where you have like the guy with the ripped chest with a dog's head on it, and they're like, come to Greg's gym or whatever the fuck it was, only it was a cat. And I could see like every single muscle in the cat. It looked like Roid Cat. And I'm like, oh,
that's not generally the sort of behavior you see in a major kitchen appliance. You know, so this is the funny story. Buddy, what eventually happened to the cat, never came home one day. I found out what happened to the cat. The cat got hit by a truck. No, the story doesn't end there. The cat got hit by a truck. My mother drove to work and saw him on the side of the road with half his face crushed, right? Whoa. So she's like, oh, cat's dead. And then 6 weeks later, in walks Buddy into her work, which was down across railroad tracks, which is in this industrial area. Cat just walks in. She's working in this fucking place with a garage door that opened. Anyway, don't worry about it. But in walks the cat, and the cat's half the cat's face is crushed, and it's all scabbed over. It's like, no, woof, woof, right?
Whoa.
This fucking robo-cat. The chick who lives there, who works there, goes, oh, okay, we're going to... I'm going to take this cat home because she's a cat lover. She spends, like, no shit, like $600 in vet bills to fix the fucking cat. Yeah, whatever. I don't know. It's a crazy bitch. So she then has five other cats, naturally, because she's a psycho cat lover. Buddy's day consisted of getting up in the morning, kicking the fuck out of her other five cats, eating all their food, going back to bed. That was his day. No shit. This day continued, much to their fucking chagrin, for about 8 months, in which case he got tired of getting up in the morning, killing five cats, no word of a lie, got up in the morning, killed two of them, because I guess they got uppity, ate all their food, part of them, and went back to fucking bed, because he didn't have the dog food anymore. The lady, somewhat, you know, upset by this, gives the cat to a pig farm. And anyone who knows anything about pig farming knows that a pig farm is the nastiest fucking place in the world to be. If you fall into a pig farm, you are fucked for life. And the cat, no shit, runs around on the floor of the pig barn killing rats and vermin. And he hides in there, and they just let the pigs in and let the pigs out to be killed. And he eats the rats and the dead pigs left behind, and Buddy is still there to this fucking day.
Wow.
That is where the cat is.
Let's go visit Buddy.
I would
Buddy.
Go try and find him, but I am afraid of the cat, because this was like my little spawn pet that fucked off and got evil.
Go
and
right
that is
over.
The story of Buddy. It's true.
Wow.
So feed your cat dog food and look at all the fun you can have.
Wow.
I thought I was going to be able to compete with that.
That's a Buddy story.
My cat, Sabbath, when he was 6 months old, tore the ear off a standard poodle. You have any idea how big a fucking standard poodle is? I get a knock on the door. The cat's basically tail's a little bent. I'm like wondering, what the fuck happened to you, Sab? And he's like...
The cat knocked on the door? Ding dong! Hey, Desmond, it's me!
No, the cat used to scratch on the front of the door until I'd let him in. He was too good to come around to the back. I swear to God. So the cat basically is in. About half an hour later, there's a knock on the door. Woman's there. She's got her dog beside her. The dog's entire head is covered in fucking bandages. She's screaming that she had to take the dog down to the vet and get its ear sewn back on.
Sorry about your luck.
I'm like,
sounds like a personal problem.
She's yelling at me. I'm like,
how about traffic? Was that bad too? Slam.
Needless to say, my cat stayed with me, and I didn't basically pay any of her fucking vet bills.
Yeah.
Anyhow.
You want to suck my what?
I basically had to get rid of the cat. They literally, I had no choice. So we gave.
You had choice.
Yeah, I did. I could have basically killed my mother and the landlord. But
it's a choice.
Yeah, I chose not to. So I gave the cat up to a couple of friends who basically, they have a farm. Now, I think I've told you this before. Mm-hmm. They had sheep on their farm.
Your cat was fucking sheep.
No. Cat basically would run around the farm. They had this one old ewe that had dropped a lamb at like the insane age of like 12 or something, which is like monstrous. It's like geriatric for fucking sheep or something like
right,
that.
Right, right, right.
And Sab used to basically stalk after the lamb because it was the only thing on the farm that was roughly its size.
Right.
So they were eating breakfast one morning, and they see Sabbath going after the lamb again. The ewe's out there eating out of the trough. There's the lamb beside it. They see the cat creeping across the entire backyard up towards where the sheep is. And they're figuring, oh, he's going to basically get at it again. And so he gets all the way over there, and all of a sudden he jumps up, and instead of going after the lamb, he jumps on the face of the ewe. The ewe lets out a bleat and falls over. Sab jumps back, takes a look. They're wondering, what the fuck's the sheep's not moving? They get up. They go out there. The sheep died of a fucking heart attack.
The cat thinks this is great fun.
True story. This is the last, well, the last buddy story, which is the only funny buddy story I actually have, because I used to have a skylight in my room. And whenever there was a, you know, the cat would come in through the skylight. He would sit outside the skylight, make that god-awful, I want to come in cat noise. Time elapsed 30 minutes. Pause. Time elapsed 30 minutes, right? Which, of course, you cannot sleep through. It's impossible. Like, to fucking use it to psyops. So I'm like, okay, fair ball. So I have my skylight open at night because anyone who knows me knows that I can, like, sleep in fucking snow. I love the cold, right? Like, -5, no problem, okay? I sleep in that shit. I love it. So I'm out, and I woke up in the middle of the night by a Siamese cat that lives down the street, which, of course, anyone who owns a Siamese cat, no, they don't. They speak in fucking vowels, man. They speak like a cat with a gun in its mouth. It's brutal. For, like, an hour, right? And I know what my cat sounds like when he's all pissed off, right? Yeah. So I hear a cat fight outside. I hear this, and I hear my cat going, and they're all fucking going at it, which makes me feel somewhat good because I know my cat's going to win because I fed him steroids, right? So I'm like, okay, that's all fair, well and good. And lo and behold, I hear this, and the Siamese cat's on top, and I hear my cat run away. And the Siamese cat is dominant. It's sitting there going on and on and on and on and on. And I'm like, oh, for the love of God, buddy, please. Somebody fucking shoot the captain. So it's, and no word of a lie, I heard a cat give another cat a short arm sickle. It sounds something like this. You have our, and here it's, and silence reigns supreme throughout the night. And you hear a couple little victorious meow, meow. And that was it. And I not only did I not hear that Siamese cat that night, I never heard from the Siamese cat again. So I think actually Buddy cut the cat's fucking head off with the side of his paw, and that was the end of it. But nevertheless, he got a full can of steroids the very next day. A short arm sickle is when you, like, if you ever look at, if you ever watch Fight Club, the guy runs down a thing and he just sticks out his arms like clotheslining. A short arm sickle is like a clothesline, only you hook your arm and you hit him with your arm in the throat rather than just clothesline. It's like a clothesline with force.
It's great for basically, it's great for basically shattering a person's trachea.
Oh yeah, you can kill people lots. So
it's time to open the phone lines now, and I'm going to play a little ditty that we have for opening the phone lines. And then a song called MTV Makes Me Want to Smoke Crack by Beck. So hopefully this is good. It's recommended by DJ Psycho, so kill him if it sucks.
Don't like it turning off.
Whoa, one second.
Passo profundo.
I can't click. It's time to open the phone lines on What the Hell. Call now, toll free, 1-604-533-9191. Pull in, pull in right now.
MTV makes me want to smoke crack.
And a smile on my face.
It's the edited version. of MTV makes me want
to smoke.
Digitally
altered it on the fly.
That's right.
Using that ripped satellite technology we stole.
It's amazing. Yeah, we've got the code if you want it. Go to ftp.rantradio.com.
No, we don't. Don't fucking bomb it looking for the code. We don't have it.
We don't have it. Download a rant and go away. Download a rant and go away. Lots of Sean K stuff there. What the hell makes me want to smoke pot?
What the hell makes you want to smoke pot? Don't smoke pot.
What the hell
makes
you not need to smoke?
What the
pot?
Hell makes you want to do vasopressin? Vasopressin, for all you little drug junkies out there, is a drug used for treating epilepsy. And what it is a nasal spray. And when you snort it, it makes your brain go faster. It's like speed for the mind. Everything you read while on vasopressin commits almost directly into immediate memory. And when you snort vasopressin again. You, in fact, can remember everything you read the first time. If you do some research on it, you'll actually find out it's true. However, the disclaimer is some side effects are it may cause anal seepage. No, in fact, what it does do is it actually causes your brain to go. You know that post, I smoked way too much pot this weekend, and my week is like, I'm so dumb during the week. I'm you're like that for like 5 days afterwards. But if you're like, wow, I really need to hack something, and I need to hack it now, jack yourself with vasopressin and some ginkgo biloba, and that'll basically do. So, no, don't smoke pot. Do things that make you smarter, not dumber, because pot and all those drugs they use to make you dumb are tools of the government. Things that make you smarter are not tools of the government.
Actually, you know the bitch. She was here a couple times.
Yep.
Her brother had this really good idea. He said they should give pot to criminals. It will demotivate
That's right.
them.
There you go. They can sit around.
They'll be smoking pot, and it'll pot demotivate them, and so they won't go out and commit crimes because they'll be demotivated by the pot.
No, there's one kind of crime that they will still be subject to. Convenience store thefts of food items.
No, they'll be demotivated to actually get off the couch.
Have you never heard of the munchies, man?
Yeah. But, you know, there's only so far you'll go. Not that I'd know. Okay, put the mic to your mouth.
Put the mic to your mouth.
Going like this.
Two large pizzas.
I think that mic's
off
now.
That is my one bad case of the munchies.
Two large. Whoa. I don't think I could ever eat that much.
Yeah.
I never thought you did drugs.
I told you that. I did them back when I was like 13, 14 years old, and then I had a friend die.
No, I know you had a buddy die. I didn't know you did them.
I did them before. That's why I stopped doing them. I had a buddy die.
Someone is here.
Hi, you're at the door of Rant Radio. Who is it?
Porn on Beta.
All right.
Who?
It's Porn on Beta.
Oh.
Do you remember who that is?
Yeah. That's, what's his big fucking...
Yep, that's the guy.
Head guy?
Who?
You'll see.
Porn on Beta.
All right,
whatever.
The artist formerly known as...
I can't remember. C-Note. Yes, have I ever met this guy? That's way back. Oh, yeah, you've been here every show for, I don't know, six months.
It's getting close to 11 o'clock. I have to work tomorrow. I am going to bail.
You're going to bail.
I'm bailing.
9 minutes before the show is over.
Oh, are we terminating at 11?
Oh, we always terminate at 11.
You've got to do the bookmark then. You got to do my two bookmarks for my tech update.
Okay. Nobody's phoning, so what the hell?
Skip you. Fuck you guys. You're not phoning. Time to do the tech update. The tech update is
so don't phone because we're not going to answer it now.
Yeah, so fuck you. Don't call. You missed your chance.
Yep, too bad.
All right, sorry. The first one is this wonderful thing. We've all heard about the concept of having electrical.
Ah, there we go. Somebody called.
All right, fuck it. Who is it?
You're on Rant Radio. You have 30 seconds.
30 seconds? That's all Skip Radio gets for this crap?
Let him talk a little longer. Okay. He's first time, long time listener, first time caller.
Okay, it's Skip Radio, so we'll let him have his piece. He's made some very, very funny comments in the IRC tonight.
Skip Radio, you rock.
Sean Kennedy basically made this the best Rant Radio it could have been this evening.
Oh, yeah. It was a good show.
It was.
It's head right growing, up there. Head swelling, too large for room, other people using
my poor ears. Top 15 show, So worship Sean Kennedy. You have as much time as you want to.
I'm going to put a Sean Kennedy worship site up tomorrow.
What's that? Say that again?
I'm going to put a Sean Kennedy worship site up tomorrow.
You do that. And the Seraphim is coming. I am going to build an online cult for people who have rejected their government. They will reject everything, and they can all become members of the new Sean Kennedy organization. Yes, it's true, because we are going to have the fucking answers, because I don't know about you, but you might as well follow me, because everybody else sucks.
I have never, ever, ever given head.
That's an official statement from Drexel. He has never, ever, ever given
Skip
head.
Radio, you kick way too much ass.
I'll definitely get you guys a link to
I'll
that.
Answer the door. How about that?
You rock.
Okay.
You guys shake it easy.
We will.
We'll take it anywhere. Say
what the hell,
man.
Thank you for phoning in.
I personally will support you
hell?
In this show.
All right. What the hell?
So long as you put me on the theological drafting committee.
Theological drafting.
I'll put you in charge of education. How about that for a fucking plan?
Minister of Education.
Okay.
High Wizard. I think the better word would be Grand Wizard.
No Grand Wizards here. All right. What we're going to do is we're getting back to the tech update. We're going to post the website on the IRC.
Already done.
This talks about how you can get over 2 gigs a second through your power lines.
Gigs.
Now that's better than fiber optic transmission for those.
Yes. Gigs. No, it's not megs.
But the beauty of this is I guarantee this is a format. This is a broadcast format. So that means that everywhere there's a fucking power plug, that means you can jack in at 2 gigs a second. How fucking sweet. I have no clue.
There it is. See, they've got the Media Fusion Control Center.
But anyway, it's at the website. Check it out.
Oh.
Now, I have a raving. I have a raving.
No,
no,
I'm just like, ooh.
No, what you want.
Bandwidth.
No, what you
through
want for bandwidth is you want
the power
the,
station.
On the last,
that's awesome.
Last tech update, I was talking about a brand new portable satellite technology where they're talking about, oh, fuck, it was,
2 megs a second.
2 megs a second.
1.5.
Over 1.5 megs per second over portable bandwidth, like so you can have a wearable.
Walk around.
And your walk around hooked in. So between the time
mic.
You go from your car to your house, you've got 1.5. You go to your house and you plug in. Or you go to the store and plug in. Or you go to a, say, lamppost or the outside of an apartment building and plug in. Anywhere there's an external power plug. It takes
one battery.
You can pack from anywhere. Any place that you can hardwire into a system, you could jack right in. No, it'll be available in the next 10 to 12 months. The
Woo-hoo!
Next device, which I have a raving, screaming hard on for. Now, everyone's heard of the Molar Sky Car.
Before you get on to the other one, will that not mean the
need
end
a mic.
Of, like, all
need
these
mic.
Fucking cable
oh, yeah.
and all these other...
If it flies, yeah. Yeah, that's it. Fuck
cable,
it.
Cable, telephone.
They're going to be trying to stop that. You know they're going
to
be trying to stop
that. They're
not
going to be able to because when it comes
Hi,
to
Hi, we're the everything company.
Yeah.
You need us.
Yeah,
the power
exactly.
company rules way more than cable.
That's true. This is from the power company?
Yes.
Yes, somebody with the power to basically crush the telephone.
Yeah, but I don't want to even know how much they're going to charge for this bitch because that'll be the limiting factor. Now, the next thing is the solo track. Now, unlike the Molar Sky Car, which has been promised to come and come, enter the flight area, by the way, Sim, if you could.
Oh, sorry.
Because we can get an actual photograph of this device.
Everyone go to
the
flight area.
What the solo track is a man-powered flying hover basically vehicle. It only weighs about 580 pounds. You have a standard ceiling of, I believe, 7,000 feet, runs on everyday gasoline, and wow, how about say you can't be stopped? Now you cross this with 1.5 megabits satellite downfeed, and you're a living, flying, hack, living destruction thing. Excuse me while you have 7,000 people descend on Area 51. Excuse me while you have people who no longer are limited by roadways. Excuse me while you have people whose biggest problem is the fact that everybody is now free and can fly. It's an amazing concept. They do not, of course, have a working model yet, because if they did, I'd have it. But it is fucking mighty. This is the thing to steal, okay?
Oh, yeah.
This thing kicks...
Only one problem.
However,
only one problem. Running out of gas is a bitch.
No, it's got backup chute systems. It's got the whole nine. The whole thing
yeah.
is it's
bring
really
a, bring it, a parachute.
Now the reason why I'm pretty excited about this is because everyone's like, oh yeah, well in 50 years we'll be able to download to the brain. Who cares? They don't have it yet. Yes, this is true. Unlike the Molar Sky Car, which they've been saying for the last fucking 10 years, oh, we're just about got it.
We just need a little more money.
Just a little bit more cash. You know, the fucking Jim Baker of the science world. Yeah, it's really brutal. This guy, I saw his initial construct and his ideas. He was looking for capital investment.
X21X.
And that was like 5 months ago.
Yeah.
And in 5 months, he's gone this far. Because it's a very simple concept.
Solo
We're not even
going to
talk
vehicle.
About weapon mounting on this motherfucker.
You know,
okay?
If they do this, if these things actually do become popular and they do think that they are actually a threat to society, you can bet the electric car will suddenly make a big influx because they will outlaw gasoline.
You can't touch flight, man. You cannot touch right.
There's a rant suggestion.
You know, do a rant on Echelon, the supposed supercomputer system that monitors all communications in North America for certain keywords.
Which they have just admitted exists.
Okay, what I need
you... 3 days ago they admitted it just
Capone
it exists.
When
yes.
you want to give out my ICQ number so that he can ICQ me
sure
some information
thing.
On that?
Anybody wants to get a hold of Sean Kennedy?
Yeah, here's my ICQ number. You got things you want me to do rants on, by all means fucking ICQ me and I will go absolutely shithawk. This is the first time I've heard of
I had heard about this, but
yeah, I've heard of concepts.
It's like a big myth.
I had heard of it. I had honestly thought that this was a myth because I didn't think they had actually gotten this far. That it actually exists. Okay, I'm not even going to basically do my usual screaming insanity on this one because this is beyond it. This is the point where I literally consider a gun.
Wow, that's one of those things where give me that IP address. Somebody give, because if it's monitoring, motherfucker, it's connected. That means it can be hacked. Good,
listening
it can listen to,
us.
To me. Ashland,
bomb, bomb, kill president.
Yes.
Bomb, nuclear plutonium, kill president. Yeah, listening, you fucking bunch of fascist cock jaws.
Fucking
rest it
on
your
logs.
Dimple, you motherfucker.
Bomb, kill president.
That's all you need.
Bomb, 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 bomb,
bomb, bomb, bomb, bomb, bomb, bomb, bomb. You know, really, you know, seriously. It's going to be the day, you know.
The laughter would die really quickly when they pounded through the door.
That's when I fuck off on my solo trek and I hit the big button on the wall that says, burn, bitch, burn. And it all goes conspiracy theory with Magnum and fucking some tetrotoxins I stole from the university, which go airborne and flood the whole floor. Fuck all y'all. We're all going to melt now. Have some sponge brain there, cat shit boy. Fuck you. Have paintballs at 300 feet per second loaded with Ebola. Sucks when you fuck with a nerd with a gun, isn't it, eh? George Hayduke is mine, man. I'll see you later, fuck nuts. Don't worry. You'll meet me again.
Well, on that
Pardon
note.
Pardon me while I go supervillain.
On that note, we're out of here. Thank you for joining us. Calamari X, Capone X, Critical S. Fourier, which is a new name. Killer Cabro, which is a new name.
Capone X, good to see you.
Yep. Lizard, Mord Sith, Shazbort, Skip Radio, and XX91X. And we are out of here. And everyone say goodbye. This is goodbye from?
Goodbye from Dak, everyone. So long.
Goodbye from Girl on the Left.
And goodbye from me. Talk hard, boys.
Oh, use that one. That's going to make a mad.
Bye from me, too.
Silent Psycho.
Bye from me.
Me? Come on.
Hey, I'm the big porn queen. You'll see my shots on the next Rant Radio.
Woohoo! Yep.
www.pornqueen.com.
All binaries porn queen.
I'm sure it's
Kate,
taken.
Kate, you're completely clueless on this mic thing. I'm just holding somewhat near you.
Kate, the last time I talked...
You have to point it in front of you like this.
Yeah, the last time I talked on a mic was actually at a... was at a concert. I was wearing a great silver mask and a cape.
Duh.
And I yelled into it and I blew out an entire club's sound system.
With a Bon
like,
Jovi
song. Whoa. I did a Metallica Bon Jovi song. And I'm not even going to do this because it makes this guy behind me cringe.
Closer.
Clasped my mouth around it.
Yeah, don't do it.
Held it like that.
Everything will die in this room.
Like that. And it was about 5 minutes of that.
Living on a prayer.
At about 0.6 seconds.
Death metal
in,
style.
Everybody who was anywhere near a speaker or a soundboard was going.
I have that song recorded on Bobbing for Logs. Maybe we'll play it next time. If
that's it.
We'll play it next time.
Anyway, that's me.
We're going to do a Bobbing.
Hello and goodbye from Porn Unbated.
Yep.
That was
the death throes of 200% sexy projectile vomit.
If anyone wants to use email to send me any links or anything, it's
Kennedy@rantradio.com. Kennedy@rantradio.com.
Kennedy@rantradio.com.
And that's bye from Anki, who did not participate too much, but he's here in spirit.
Hi.
And,
fuck off.
And Drexel is on the phone. Maybe he'll say goodbye. But
say goodbye, Drexel.
Say goodbye, Drexel. Okay, you
he
may have heard
bye.
That. He said bye. And this is bye from Sumerian. Till
next
week.
See you next week.
In six days and 22 hours.
And I'm going to make a commitment that I'm going to have some new rants for next weekend.
Kick ass.
Woo.
That kicks ass. Okay, this is bye-bye.
Yeah, fuck, guys are sending me. You have just listened to another episode of What the...